And welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey. There we go. Not this again.
Oh, oh my God.
I can't take any more pain now.
A couple phone numbers in the New York City area. 877-692-1027. Outside of New York City, 866-277-4WOW. That's 866-277-4WOW.
Look what he's doing now.
Huh? Can I hear the yesterday one again? Because today is yesterday or whatever.
Today was yesterday because yesterday was so close, like almost like it was the same day.
Nice logic.
It makes sense.
On some strange level.
This is the Iron Sheik, the World Wrestling Federation champion. Pleasure for me to the Anthony and Opium. They're bringing me to the WNEW. Is one of the number one station in the Manhattan and New York. And pleasure to have come here. I want to say hello to the, all my wrestling fans and hello to the all people to the wrestling, to the WNEW station, number one radio station in New York. And pleasure to have you here.
Yeah, I hear me.
All right.
And pleasure to be here.
Well, we played that because there's a guy on the line claiming that the Iron Sheik got thrown out of a casino last night. Mike, what's going on?
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Pretty good,
Bill. Mike's not my real name. I'm doing that to protect myself.
Ah, his real name is Pete.
Yes. Last night, he was formally ejected from a casino in Atlantic City. He was playing Caribbean stud poker, and after a few hours, he got a little intoxicated. Actually, he was three sheets to the wind. And he was warned twice on being loud and belligerent. You know, he's just using all kinds of foul language and screaming hell he's famous and this, that, and the other thing. So we had to
warn him. Don't you know who I am? Gag, 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 gag.
Absolutely. He then offered us his apology by trying to sign us autographs.
Now, are you sure this was the Iron Sheik? Because I know there's another Iron Sheik going around that says he's the Iron Sheik, but he does stand-up comedy badly.
Oh, I'm a huge WWF fan for a long time now, and it was definitely him.
Yeah?
Oh, horrible. Anyway, about an hour later, he continued to be belligerent and lost a lot of his money. So he went to shove a guy off of a seat next to him and started screaming. And he reached for one of the dealers and tried swinging at him. So he went bye-byes.
Well, can we get the Iron Sheik on the air today, Rick? You got a contact for him? Yeah, we'll try to get the Iron Sheik on the show to see his story in this whole thing.
Right.
Iron Sheik.
All right, Mike, thank you.
Have a good one, guys.
Thank you.
I have a drunk celebrity story from goddamn mega years ago, man. My my father married a woman that worked at a bar, a nightclub type thing out in California. And what the hell's his name? He did the Lone Wolf McQuade and the karate guy.
Oh, Chuck Norris.
Chuck Norris. Chuck Norris wasn't really a big movie star yet, but he was a kung fu star. You know, he's like karate star.
Right.
And whatnot. What, that he's eating?
He's eating. He's not on a mic.
He's just in the background.
All right, go.
Just go like this every so often.
Hey.
Hey. Yeah. So Chuck Norris was, he was like a champion as far as his martial arts go. And he had been in a couple of movies. Well, he was tanked drunk in my stepmother's club. And he was being belligerent with people. He got all drunk. And some guy, he was hitting on some guy's girlfriend. And this guy was like, back off, man. And the guy got right, Chuck Norris got right in his face. He goes, I'm Chuck Norris, mother F. I'm champion of this, that, the other thing. Chuck Norris proceeded to get his ass kicked.
No way.
His drunken kung fu ass kicked all over this bar. And you know, then he went on to become famous in all the movies. But that story always stuck in my head of how just some guy in a bar beat the living crap out of him.
Classic.
He was drunk.
Well, Ann, I might be able to top you today.
Why?
I went to a sushi restaurant downtown last night.
You did?
And we're in this bar waiting for our reservation to come up. And Sandy, my girlfriend there, she's convinced that Captain Kangaroo is at the bar. Is Captain Kangaroo dead?
Yes, he is.
He's dead,
stop
right?
It. Was the guy at the bar sitting on a satin pillow?
Was he? Is he, I mean? Someone find out if Captain Kangaroo is dead.
I got one of my...
She swore that it was Captain Kangaroo without a mustache.
Captain Kangaroo.
It was getting a little too loud, and this guy, who looks, I guess, a little bit like Captain Kangaroo, was very pissed off that Sandy was claiming that he was Captain Kangaroo, and then started giving me dirty looks, and I thought we were going to have to fight. So now I need to know if this guy was Captain Kangaroo or not. What is going on?
Loud noise.
I know. There's so much crap going on today. It's not even funny. We'll get to what's going on outside the studio in a second.
Kangaroo.
Someone just let me know if Captain Kangaroo is alive or dead, okay?
I'm looking at that find a grave thing, but I don't know if you could put Captain Kangaroo in there.
No, what was his real name?
I think you need his name.
Find a grave? Wow, what is...
Oh, find a grave. You put in a celebrity's first name and last name, and it tells you where they're buried, their tombstone, a picture of their tombstone.
Wow.
It's great. The internet. It's wonderful. Maybe, Internet Movie Database. That probably.
You got to know his real name.
What?
You could just punch in Captain Kangaroo.
Kangaroo. I hope that's how you spell Kangaroo.
Anyone on the instant feedback coming up with the answer to that little question?
Captain Kangaroo, 1955. His name, Robert Keeshan. As I click on his name, Robert Keeshan, it doesn't have a death name thing for him. June 27, 1927. He is, as far as this says, still alive. Big Kev would definitely know.
Big Kev!
I do believe he's alive.
Yes, I do see that.
And he's old, but I do believe he is alive.
So you may have seen Captain Kangaroo yesterday.
Yeah, you may have seen him. Was he pretty old, though?
Yeah, so I almost was in a fight with the real Captain Kangaroo last night.
Well, how did you almost get in a fight with somebody born in 1927?
Because the guy was really pissed off, and he didn't want to be bothered. I wasn't sure if he was pissed off because we noticed it was Captain Kangaroo, or if we were claiming that he was Captain Kangaroo.
Did you?
The guy was giving us nasty looks.
Captain Kangaroo doesn't want to be bothered.
Can you imagine if you get your ass kicked by Captain Kangaroo?
Did he still have that horrible haircut?
Did he have the Captain Kangaroo haircut?
No, not really.
That big bowl on his head thing, the Dutch boy, whatever it was?
He didn't have the mustache, so we couldn't really tell for sure.
I believe Mr. Green Jeans is dead.
Ah.
Yes, he is.
Mr. Green Jeans.
Yeah, he's dead.
That would be Hugh Branham. Hugh Branham. He died in 1987.
Yes, that's right.
All right, thank you, Big Cat.
Wealth of information with this newfangled internet.
All right, there's a lot going on. Thank you, Keith the Cop.
Mm-hmm.
Keith the Cop brought us a homeless person today, Anthony.
Well, this is one of our friends from the homeless shopping spree,
and he's already horrifying the new interns.
He looks a little beat up.
Yeah, what happened to him?
He does look a little beat up. He said,
Did you tune him up?
He says he fell down the steps.
Ah.
He fell down, he said.
That's what the cops tell him to say. Tell him you fell down the steps.
Wait, Steve, why are you making that look? Get on mic. Steve from foundrymusic.com. Great clips of Smokey bothering Jim Norton up on foundrymusic.com.
Yeah, not anymore.
Is that Tippy Tom? That's Tippy Tom out there,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
He's a babbling, drunken bum.
you just heard that.
All right, get him in here. Tippy Tom was one of the homeless people we had for the homeless shopping spree. Here, Steve, why don't you stand right about there?
There you go. And Rick,
yes,
of course, is
I
right
saw
here
him last week at about 10:15 in the morning, and he was completely hammered.
Here on the fire.
Oh, my
All right,
goodness.
What I'm trying to say is this. Here's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
What am I trying to say?
You got a summer tan, bro, and a nice new... nice new sporty hairdo.
Yeah, I'm trying to say that.
It's very Kiefer Sutherland.
No, yeah, isn't saying, it? You look like Kiefer Sutherland,
I'm
all
saying,
beat
up. If we had shots around, I don't know.
He's putting the beer in his pocket.
Now, what I'm trying to say
it's
is
open.
This.
Yes.
You want to hear a joke?
Oh, a joke, a little comedy.
It might be it. It's a guy joke.
Uh-oh. Are there dirty words in it? You can't say dirty words.
All right. Wonder Woman was on the beach with her legs open.
I know this joke.
What are you opening up for Voss?
Four Fantastics. Superman saw Wonder Woman, and he flew down and did a little thing. He got in. And then Hawk Cousin He went down there.
Who?
He did it.
Who?
Oh, the Hulk.
Oh, the Hulk.
The Hulk. He did a little bit with Wonder Woman. And then the Rock Man, he come down. He did his thing. Anyway, they all go back.
Wait, what's the thing they're doing?
Wait. Let me get through this joke. And they all get back to the fort. And the Invisible Man shows up and says, "My ass is sore as hell."
Somehow it's so much funnier when you tell it.
Doesn't he look like he should be on a raft being rescued after about 8 years at
Wilson,
sea?
Wilson!
You look like you've been shipwrecked.
He looks like he's been shipwrecked.
Look, and now he's posing for the camera.
Didn't he used to be a gigolo? I'm trying to remember Tippy Thomas.
Were you a hustler out on the street? Were you a hustler out on the street?
I'm a hustler. You're damn right I'm a hustler. I hustle the best. I've been on the street. I know how to shake my thing. You're damn right. I'm a hustler from way uptown to downtown. You're damn right. I hustle.
Tippy Tom.
Big bucks.
Tippy Tom.
Tippy Tom got big bucks.
Tippy Tom, where did it all go wrong for you? Somewhere on your road in your life, something went wrong that made you end up where you are today out on the street. What was it?
Well, I started back in San Francisco.
Yeah.
I went to a bar.
Right.
When I ran away from home.
Why'd you run away from home?
Oh, felt like it. And I went in there. Yeah. I hitchhiked. And I was in a bar.
Right.
And I'm sitting at the bar.
Defining moment coming up.
On Market Street in San Francisco.
Right.
And somebody came up. Oh, I can't say this.
Oh, go ahead.
You want to say it?
Yeah, go ahead. Say it.
Wait a minute.
Don, you can't say that. That's true.
Hold on.
You can't say that. But
okay, you can't say that. Someone came up
to
you.
Say gave you a...
Wait.
All right, we're out of dump here.
Hold on. Shut up, Tippy Tom, for a minute. Stop. He's killing us. Tippy Tom, you can't... You can't say that. So Aunt and I...
All right, I can't say that.
No. You can't use that. So just say Hummers.
A lot of clean stuff.
The guy gave you a Hummer, so you decided to give him a Hummer, right?
Hummers. Just say Hummer. A Hummer. A guy gave you a Hummer. Just say a Hummer.
A Hummer?
Guy gave you a Hummer, and then you decided to start giving Hummers?
Yeah, Hummers.
Yeah. All right.
And that's what happened?
Yeah.
Why is that? If some guy... Some guy walked up to you in a bar and said, "I want to, you know, give you a Hummer." And you said, "Okay."
A Hummer? What's a Hummer?
Well, everyone knows what it is, so don't worry about it. And you said okay?
Cool.
Right. And you said okay.
Yeah. Hey, let me tell you a little joke I made up.
All right, boss.
There's this lady. This guy joke. She's in the airport. She got arrested. They lifted up her dress, and they found 2 tons of crack. You don't get it, do you?
That's the Oprah Winfrey joke. You
yeah.
Jesus. You got it.
We got it, Tippy.
I have no act. So what happened? So this guy gives you a Hummer, you give the Hummer back, and that's where it went all wrong?
Yeah,
you decide you liked it?
It was like Hummer. What's it called again?
Hummer.
Hummer?
Hummer.
Hummer.
So it was like Hummer.
Hummer after Hummer after Hummer.
So you just kept giving them.
No, I ain't stop giving. I gave a Hummer this the other day. And then I got a Hummer myself.
Wait, who did
what
you... Who did you give a Hummer to the other day?
Well, I got a buddy that I hang out with.
Yeah, what's his name?
And he liked to get the Hummer.
Right.
You know, so I do the Hummer, and then he do the Hummer. And then that's what it was. But there's other things that happened.
You're a good friend.
Like what? What other things?
I can't say it on the radio.
What?
Well, just say it.
No, I think he could say it.
Yeah, you could probably say it.
Yeah.
Wait. I think he could say it.
I think he could say it.
Wait a minute.
Hold on. Don't say anything. Keith, shut him up. Shut him up.
What? How did I know that's what he was going to say? Wait a minute, Tom. Hold on.
Hold on. Wait a minute.
All right, get him out.
Hold on, Tom.
Wait, Tom.
Where's he? No, don't get him. Wait a minute, Tom.
All right, Timmy Tom has left the studio.
I don't know what to say.
I don't know what made the radio, but it looks like he
took it in the balloon knot.
He likes
what happened. He goes, you know, I'll say it. I like to get. He said it.
You know how bad that must be to do to a homeless man?
Oh, my God. You know back there is just all brambles and...
By the way, Anthony, that's not Tippy Tom.
Who is it?
That's our new consultant, John Minoli.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
He has been brought in to clean up this place.
Look, I just have to make sure. You're not the friend he was talking about.
I know. That's friends, boy. Let me tell you.
Keith, you're going to just let him wander the hallways?
No. He's in the bathroom.
Oh, good. Doesn't... You just know he doesn't have many bathing facilities. So when he does this, like you just said, some balloon knot action that he got from his friend.
Oh, he said it much better than that, dog.
Oh, he went right for the F word and everything.
There's like 15 people on hold right now that really enjoyed that last exchange.
Oh, my God, yeah.
And you know, to get to the balloon knot, when you peel certain, it's got to sound like a fruit roll-up coming off the...
The smell has to be horrendous. The smell has to be... Because it's just bad coming off of them anyway, but imagine that area.
Yeah.
Like you ever pass by a dead animal and that pungent smell of... rotting flesh.
Hey, you guys, I got an idea.
Yeah.
What if Lady Di gave Tippy Tom...
Oh, my God.
Can you get Lady Di in the...
Oh, my God. This is good.
I won't even put it to a vote. If Lady Di does this, she stays with
the
radio.
She stays on the show. Oh, boy.
And so does he for tolerating that.
Get Tippy Tom back in here. I got to make sure he goes that way as well. Matt, what's up?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
That was the best show yesterday. Absolute best. Staple Gun Roulette just rocked. You guys are the king.
There you go. We're going to up the ante. We're doing nail guns next time.
Oh, I got a better contest for you. Why don't you fill, you get like 9 super soakers, and you fill one of them with urine. And one unlucky guy.
I like that one.
Where's Tippy Tom?
He's in the bathroom.
Still? All right.
Uh-oh.
Well, we're trying to get Lady Di. Lady Di has until tomorrow to figure out what she's going to do for the show.
What the hell is she going to do for the show? That is so sick. He sure told us a lot.
Hey, Dan, what's going on?
What's happening, guys?
You tell me.
You guys know what today is, don't you?
Happy birthday to you.
Thursday the 13th of June.
Olsen twins, 16 years old today.
Oh,
happy birthday to Mary Kate and Ashley Olsen.
We got a homework. We have a homework assignment for someone on the instant feedback.
Mm-hmm.
You got to tell us how many states the Olsen twins are legal in.
How many states are the Olsen twins legal in?
Thank you, Dan. Why wait to 18, Anthony?
Now, wait, what are we looking at here?
There can only be a certain number of years difference between them and the person they're with, though.
Oh, is that true?
Yes.
Yeah, no, not necessarily.
No, that's not true.
No, stop it.
16, you can't be 16 and 33.
What is MF?
Not female.
Male, female. You mean there are different ages for different type of sex?
Yeah. All right. Always older for the, younger for the guy, right?
So is it true that the Olsen twins are now legal in Alabama?
Alabama.
They are now legal in Alaska, Anthony.
Wow.
They are now legal in Arkansas.
Figures. In Colorado, the guy can be 15, but the girl has to be 17.
Huh.
No good for Colorado. Good news, Anthony. Olsen twins now legal in Connecticut.
Connecticut.
That's close.
Wow, that is close.
They are now legal. Ready for this? D.C. Come on.
Get that cigarette around here. Give me Tom back and tell
Give him one, Ben. Give him a cigarette.
Give me a cigarette.
Give him a cigarette.
Give me Tom a cigarette.
Ben, give him a cigarette.
You got a cigarette?
Here, you can take
Where are you?
I don't have one.
Tippy Tom, you can take it right out of his back pocket.
No, you can't.
Oh, look at Ben's cursing, man.
What's up with this? You got a cigarette?
No.
Earl, what's Earl?
He's been laughing at him.
All right, what I'm saying is this.
Tom, what happened to your eye?
I fell down the stairs.
What stairs?
At 8th Avenue, Port Authority, down there. It was raining a couple days ago.
And you fell down the stairs.
Down the one side on 14th Street, and then I slipped on the water, and I went all the way down. Bang my head.
Imagine seeing that happen. Would you just be laughing your ass off if you saw him going ass over tea kettle?
What happened was this.
Yeah.
I woke up, I'm bleeding like crazy.
Right.
I think it's time to go to the hospital. And I got
him on mic.
Block.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't going to, I don't like doctors, period. So
obviously.
I just like stayed there and by the church. Next to the hospital, St. Vincent's, downtown.
Yeah.
Bleeding more. And somebody called the ambulance and said that I have to go to the hospital. And I said, yeah, you think so? So the blood has come gushing out of me. And I said, I think maybe you're right. And so... they call an ambulance.
Yeah.
Put me in there. I'm bleeding all over the bed. Everything is just coming out like a mother. I couldn't believe how much blood I lost.
Right.
And that's why I did an infusion. Donate some blood, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And
imagine slipping in that puddle of whatever.
And what happened was... is that they wanted to stitch me up, but I didn't feel like getting a stitch. It was too painful. They wouldn't give me no... St. Vincent's wouldn't give
you
me
You take
no.
your buddy's junk and your
no,
balloon knot?
No, I'm mad at St. Vincent's right now.
No, you take your buddy's...
pissed off at them.
You take your buddy's junk inside your balloon knot, and yet that hurts? The doctor's stitching you?
What?
Your buddy. You said he put his junk in your balloon knot.
Oh, that was last week. I'm talking
But the eye hurts?
And I hit my head.
Yeah, but what about your ass?
I fell downstairs. My nose? Well, I don't know how to do that. But I'll figure it out.
Hey, I want to know where he has all this action.
What I'm saying is that...
if he's a homeless guy.
Hey, where do you go to have sex?
And the cops were not around. Where are the cops when I'm banged up?
Tippy Tom, where do you go with your friend
Tippy
to have
Tom,
this...
I want
to
know why the... oh, Jesus, that cops don't have no problem picking on the homeless, writing out tickets. But where you at when we fall down, bust our ass?
All right, calm down, George Carlin.
Yeah.
Hey, Tippy Tom. It's okay.
Yeah.
I got it down the hall. Tippy Tom, I got to ask you a question.
Yeah.
Where do you go to have these sexual encounters with your friend if you're homeless?
I don't talk about getting laid. It depends. I haven't for a long time.
You said just last week.
Well, he's a little scared because Pisa Cop is right next to him.
Let's see.
Where do you go?
Last week, I forget who it was with. Because I'm a slut.
Homeless slut. But where do you go? You got to have some privacy somewhere, right?
Well, yeah, I know where to go with privacy. Well, I usually hang downtown. Uptown, no privacy, too many people.
So downtown what? You go into an alley and bend over a garbage pail?
Somewhere around behind a dumpster or something like that. And,
imagine walking down that alley, turning your head past the dumpster, and just seeing Tippy Tom get nailed in his balloon knot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
when I get...
When you get banged.
When I get banged, I like the jerk.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Wait. All right, we understand, but he can't say
that. Hold on.
Well, he likes to, yeah. All right, hold on. Let me down.
Yeah.
Sick ass. He likes to get banged, but then he likes to take care of himself while he's getting banged.
I like to, yeah.
Right, just say that. That's okay. Don't say that.
Yeah. Right.
But so you like to take care of yourself while the guy is taking care of himself with you.
Yeah, exactly. If we go that way, it may go the other way.
Always.
So I might have to do him like
the reach around. You got to give the reach around.
Do him like that.
Wow. This guy is...
You're a good egg.
Get on.
Wow, what a trooper.
That's the way it goes.
Do you like girls too, Tippy Tom?
I had a girlfriend. Yeah. And I...
In Niagara Falls, Ontario, Canada.
What?
Yeah.
Let's hear about this girlfriend.
Let's hear about the girl in your life.
Because we want a girl...
I only have one girlfriend my whole life.
Really? Did you have sex with her?
Yeah,
and you didn't enjoy it.
The thing she liked me too. Can I say it on air?
Well, I don't know.
Wait,
do you think?
Well, let's think about this.
Do you think you can say it?
Yeah, I think typically.
Don't say it. No. All right, he couldn't say that.
Wait. Hold on, Tom. Don't say it. Don't say it again.
I think we.
Oh my God.
I think we just found our new midday show here in New York.
Oh my God. Okay. Wow. He likes.
He likes to go dining. Anthony.
Right. He likes to eat at the Y.
He likes to dine. Yes.
All right, Tom. Don't say that though. But we understand. Just say you like to eat at the Y.
Eat it for what?
You know, you eat at the Y.
Eat at the Y.
Eat at the Y.
Okay.
All right. So she wanted you to do that.
Eat at the Y.
Eat at the Y. You know.
Well, that's what I did.
All right. And did she enjoy it?
Eat at the Y.
Did she like it?
That's what I did.
And?
Was Tippy it... Tom know how to do that?
Did she enjoy it, Tippy Tom?
I don't know if she liked it or not.
Yeah? But you it turned out you liked...
She was bumping my face.
That means she liked it, Tom.
Right.
Is that... Okay,
that's okay.
That's good.
But then, Tom.
On my face.
Tom, at one point, then, you decided you liked men more than women?
Well, I like them both. Now, the thing is, I had more boyfriends than girlfriends.
Right.
But my boyfriend, Gary, well, you know, we broke up. And the one girlfriend I had, Philomena, she didn't like me because I was going out with Gary. And so I was like, you know, what am I going to do? I'm dizzy.
Why'd you break up with Gary? Was it over the hockey game with Oak?
No, I didn't break up. Gary was mad because I wanted to stay with Philomena, too.
Right.
Yeah.
I wanted them both. I wanted a bimbo on my right, a bimbo on my left. I wanted two bimbos. And they didn't like
Tom. Did you ever, you know, when we were talking about
eating?
Tom, wait a minute. When we talk about eating at the Y with a girl, did you ever do that to a guy where you know, go around back?
Oh.
Tom, you can't say that.
No! Hold on.
Okay, hold on. Keith, shut him up. Be quiet. Why are you going to delay?
I'm trying to say it in a way, and he just comes out and says it.
I'm just screaming to cover up anything else he's saying.
He's just yelling he's a slut.
I know, but he was saying something else, too. So Tippy Tom has...
tossed salad.
Yes, he
tossed salad.
Yeah,
I don't think we heard that. It's okay.
All right, Tom, why don't you take a break? Okay.
Pop down someone on the phone lines. I want to see if they're hearing this.
Yeah, let's go to John.
John. Hey, John.
Hey, what's going on?
Have you heard we're dumping out of here on the show with Tom?
Yeah. Hey, I got a question. I've been waiting on. Is this guy white or black?
White.
A white guy.
He's a white dude?
Yeah, he looks like. What would you say he looks like?
He looks like Kiefer Sutherland if Kiefer Sutherland was beat up.
Now, when he gets shot in that film when he's in court, that's what he looks like.
I think he looks like... He does. He's got, like, light hair. So he looks like a guy that's been on a life raft for 3 or 4 months out in the sun, all beat up, with a big beard and everything, just trying to be rescued.
What's happening?
He used the bathroom.
There was seems to be a little mishap in the bathroom.
What happened? Opie's going to look. Opie is going to look. A mishap in the bathroom? Oh, and Jim Norton's going, I can't look. Right, Ben?
Nope.
Because stuff like this totally disgusts me. Did he? Oh, my God. Open that door. Hold the door open. Let me hear the reaction. He's talking about the intern. We got a new girl intern. Uh-oh. What's the matter, Jim?
Awful.
What was it?
It's just,
it looks like butterscotch pudding all over the bowl.
Damn.
And the seat, and the back of the seat, and...
It's actually a nice color for a throw rug.
all over the back of the seat and everything?
smeared.
Why don't we take a break? Man juice will lighten up that color. That might be what it was.
Where are we going with this?
All mixed in there.
Are we going to try to get Lady Di to do something to Tippy Tom?
Yes. Yes. What do you want her to do? Toss salad? Dude, what about it? Come on, you got to go for the gusto. She's got to toss his salad.
If she just gives a hummer or lets Tippy Tom do the Y, the ultimate rusty truck. You guys are crazy. That will never happen.
What if she...
She will never do
She's got to toss salad. I think tossing salad.
I think the odds are slim to none that she'll even just do the hum.
What if we let Tippy Tom eat at the Y? Oh,
that's far worse for him.
That is, but it's funny as hell.
Well, where the hell is she?
She's not at home.
All right. Well, Lady Di, you need to call the show immediately, okay? And we'll take a break.
Oh, God, that is disgusting.
Yeah. He's just sitting on the IKEA furniture.
Screaming
and yelling.
He's barking. He's barking. He likes you, huh? Yeah.
All right, we'll continue with Tippy Tom next.
Opie Anthony.
Their psychosis is all real. This is not an act.
Ponderous. Effing ponderous. The Opie and Anthony Show.
We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show.
Let's do it!
Let's do it! On our hotline, Anthony, the Iron Sheik.
Ah, pleasure for me. He had a little trouble, I guess. We spoke to a guy that works at a casino down in Atlantic City and said that the Iron Sheik was getting a little intoxicated and boisterous and had to be removed from the casino. Well, we always give equal time here on the Opie and Anthony Show. So right now, the Iron Sheik. Iron Sheik, how are you doing?
Fine, thank you, Sir Rick. How are you?
What a good Iron Sheik. It's pleasure for me to talk to you, Iron Sheik.
God bless you, first of all, to you think about the real champion from oldest country in the world, Persia or Iran. I made it to the most famous city in the world, Madison Square Garden, New York, and a single tag team. And God bless you, called me, and I want to also say
yes.
Thank you to the last time that Jabroni, my agents, Steve Chaplin,
yeah.
Bring me over there, and with Eric Simpson, I want to say hello to all my wrestling friends. God bless you. You think about me and call me, Rick. Talk to me.
Wow. It's a pleasure for us, Iron Sheik.
Pleasure for us.
You're live on the radio with Opie and Anthony, of course, and we heard that you had some problem in a casino last night.
Well, in the casino, people come in, they want to autograph, and then there was too many people, and
yeah.
We go in the street with Steve Chaplin, and the road closed, and then thousand people were, and the officer said, "No, Sheik, you have to go. You cannot." The Manhattan street was closed.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir, and all my wrestling fans recognize that the real Iron Sheik Khosrow Waziri from Iran, Tehran, and Shah Ahmad Rezaiyam midre ke Khosrow Waziri kye. I want to say, Rick, God bless you. Think about me. I'm training 90 degrees. I'm going to come to the Manhattan, I hope, pretty soon.
And what was that place you played here in Manhattan?
Well, I go to the Broadway and my company, the World Wrestling Federation, WWF restaurant, and usually all my wrestling fans come over and I sign a picture for them, make him happy, because my boss, Mr. McMahon, greatest boss, and God bless his father and his son and Shane and all his daughter, all intelligent people. I want to say hello to everybody. Yeah. God bless you. Think about me.
Iron Sheik, what was the big arena that you played in New York City?
Well, the biggest arena, the most famous arena, Madison Square Garden, New York, number one arena, number right. one bashkah in the world. خدمت همه شنوندگان ایرانیم سلام عرض میکنم موفقیت شما را آرزو The most famous arena in the world is Madison Square Garden, New York, 24-hour city.
Yes, 24-hour city, New York.
Hey, didn't you fight the Hulk once?
Yes, sir. I beat Mr. Bob Backlund 6 years. Nobody beat him, included my best friend, Mr. Bruno Sammartino.
Yeah, we're
whatever. None of them beat him. I beat him, and then I didn't feel good. I lost my belt to the Jabroni Hulk Hogan and Madison Square Garden, New York.
But didn't you eventually beat Hulk Hogan?
Yes, sir. I can beat him even right now. Hulk Hogan is a guitar player. He's not an Olympic wrestler. He's not an AAU wrestler. He never been any compete in the overseas or Olympic. He's all of a showman and a bodybuilder. And he used the gimmick A to the Z himself.
Yes.
And he tell the kids or nobody else don't do it.
Right.
Yeah. I beat the Jabroni in 85 and I still today I can beat him too. Yes, sir, Rick, I'm ready.
Now, if you were to get a fight with Hulk Hogan here in New York, where would be the best place to do that so the most people could see it?
The most famous arena in the world, Madison Square Garden, New York. And I think it's in the heart of the Manhattan. And if any jabroni doesn't know about Madison Square Garden, New York, that means something wrong with
right.
his friend.
Absolutely.
Yes,
absolutely.
We're really not familiar with that room, Iron Sheik.
I'm sorry, say it again, sir.
We're not really familiar with that room.
What room?
That garden room.
But I'll be honest with you, sir. I born in Tehran, Iran, the most oldest city in the world. And all my brother was a wrestler.
Yes.
Like Oram Reza Tassi, Habib Zandi.
Greco-Roman.
I don't want to keep you too long. Rick, don't insult my intelligence, Baba. I'm the real champion. Not that you're running Hulk Hogan.
Right.
Ask Anthony and ask Opie. They'll tell you, Baba.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Ya Allah. I want to say hello to all my wrestling fans in the most famous city in the world, Madison Square Garden, Manhattan, New York, Long Island, all my students, especially Long Island. I want to say hello to all of them. God bless them. And in the next couple of weeks, I hope my agents, Steve Kaplan or the Jabroni Eric Sims, maybe they invite me again. Always pleasure for me.
Always
and God
pleasure.
Bless you guys. Think about me.
Pleasure for us, Iron Sheik.
Hey, Iron Sheik, you ever meet Tippy Tom behind a dumpster?
I'm not good for a joke, Baba. Nicola, my partner,
yes.
He locked the rib and joke. I'm not joking. I'm a real
Nikolai Volkov
gold medal for toughest sport in the world, freestyle and Greco-Roman. Not Michael Jordan, sport world, or not football, Joe Namon. I'm the individual Olympic gold medal.
Iron Sheik. Iron Sheik. Nikolai Volkov, he fought, Sergeant Slaughter. Here in New York. I can't remember where that was, though.
Oh, well, usually, Nicola and myself tag team with the greatest manager in the world, Mr. Howard Fingono, and Mr. Fred Blassie was my manager, Nicola and
yeah.
I. We beat that all-American boys, they call him born USA, Mr. Mac Rotondo and Mr. Barry Windham.
I remember I saw that Nikolai Volkov and Sergeant Slaughter bout, but I can't remember where that was here in New York.
Rick, you should be intelligent, Bobo. And a soldier, myself, the most Fred the Moose, the famous match was a Campbell match, Madison Square Garden, New York. And Sergeant Renaud, they called Campbell match. That was one of the most wrestling history,
yes.
That match. Yes,
I remember that. That was famous.
It's the memory of a goldfish.
Yeah. Iron Sheik, pleasure for us, Iron Sheik, to speak it to you. Number one wrestler, Greco-Roman, from oldest country, Iran, Tehran. A wonderful
freestyle and Greco-Roman.
And Greco-Roman.
Plus WWF single,
yes.
Tag team with Nicola and Badr Royal. And God bless Mr. McMahon. Didn't forget about his real champion. And I was there. I'm happy. God bless
yes.
You guys. Call me. Always pleasure to talk to you guys, Rick.
Very
and say
pleasure.
Hello to my cousin Anthony and also Opie.
Right, and pleasure for us,
God
Iron
bless
Sheik.
You.
All right, any final thoughts, Iron Sheik?
I'm sorry, sir?
Any final thoughts before we let you go?
Fight?
No, any final thoughts? Any other thing you want to say before we let you go, Iron Sheik?
If you don't mind, I want to say hello quick to all my Muslim and Iranian brother, Farsi. Hello, just a couple seconds if you don't mind.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, assalamu alaikum, khidmate hame shanavandegan Irani aziz ke dar New York va dar New Jersey zindagi mikunan. Salam arz mikunam, muvaffaqiyat shoma ro arzu mikunam. Khosro vaziri, qahramon Iran و احمد رضایی میدونه ما از کجا اومدیم یا الله یا محمد یا علی and also I want to say hello to my good friend Sonny Beach and Greg and also big Bob and I hope pretty soon I'm going to come to Manhattan again hello
very good thank you so much Iron Sheik pleasure for us
God bless you thank you again anytime no problem sir
and maybe we'll see you here in New York in the biggest arena ever.
In the world, Madison Square Garden. If any jabroni doesn't know about Madison Square Garden, New York, the most famous arena in the world, something wrong with that jabroni brand. Because if Aaron Sheik can make it, you can make it too. But you have to want it. You have to train it. You have to really think in about that gold medal. Ya Allah, Ya Muhammad. And my brother Muhammad Ali know, and Joe Frazier know, and the most famous athlete in the world for boxing, my brother Muhammad Ali, the greatest, and then for wrestling, the Iron Sheik, both of them in Madison Square Garden, New York.
Thank you so much, Iron Sheik. It was a pleasure talking to you.
God bless you, sir.
Thank you.
Good night.
Oh, wait, Iron Sheik?
Yes, sir.
You've got the Iron Sheik. You had a killer line. He has a memory like a goldfish. So, Obi, did he get kicked out of that casino?
I don't know.
Like we were going to get an answer to that one.
And then during that, Tippy Tom is yelling and screaming. He wants back in the studio to sing his Rod Stewart song. We got porn stars outside the station.
This is gearing up to be a fun one, kids.
Gearing up to be another cluster F with your pals Opie and Anthony.
New York shock jocks Opie and Anthony are now on the air.
Welcome to the wonderful world of balloon knot pleasure.
Yeah, if you need lube, you're a loser. Take it like a champ, okay?
The Opie and Anthony Show.
Spreading like AIDS in Haiti.
You're checking out the Opie and Anthony Show. We don't know what's happening today, but we'll continue, I guess. Pleasure for us to be here today. We got a lot of porn stars outside the studio. Tippy Tom, the homeless guy's outside the studio.
Tippy Tom.
Getting hammered. He wants to sing his Rod Stewart song, Anthony. Lady Di is on hold. Well, tomorrow is the day for Lady Di. Tomorrow is the day. We gave her about a week and a half. And tomorrow's the deadline for her to come up with an idea that she will present to us and perform. Well, I don't know. It could be a stunt. It could be her sitting in front of a mic and talking. Just anything that might impress the listeners. And the listeners will be put to a vote, and they will decide whether Lady Di will be on our show ever again, or if she will just disappear. Lady Di!
Yes, hi. How you doing, Opie and Anthony?
Pretty good.
How's everything? Hi, Jim.
Hi, Jim. Boy, that heavy, nervous breathing.
So, no.
Lady Di, you come up with any other ideas for tomorrow? Or?
I just have a few, that's all.
Well, tomorrow's the day, so now's the time to tell us.
Okay, well, I'm going to stick to my singing tomorrow. I heard what you said before. I don't think I'm going to go that drastic.
The singing thing's going to get you kicked off our radio show.
You know that, right?
Well, then I'll come up with something different then by tomorrow.
You have one day.
I know. I know how long I have.
Get Tippy Tom in here. I think there's something we can work out.
Maybe there's something we can work out.
Oh, no.
Dave,
oh
on line three, you're saying have Lady Di do a Tippy Tom butt chug.
A Tippy Tom what?
Butt chug. You like beer.
Yeah.
I don't think so. No.
All right. Is he coming in? I could hear him yelling out there.
He has to finish chugging the beer first.
Make sure he stays on mic the whole time because he tends to drift.
Oh, thank you.
Look, he's got WOW shirt and WOW hat on now.
What are we talking about?
He has his WOW stuff
he's
on now.
He's got all of his WOW attire on. Tippy Tom.
Good.
Hey, Tom. On the phone right now is Lady... Lady Di is on the phone. Say hi to Lady Di.
Lady Dot?
Yeah.
Hi, Tippy Tom.
Hi, Lady Dot. How are you?
All right. How you doing?
Can you hear her?
Can you hear me?
Let's make sure. Say it again, Lady Dot.
Say it again, Lady Dot.
Hi, Tippy Tom.
Hi. How are you?
All right. How are you?
I'm all right.
That's good.
Yeah, man. Just hanging out.
Right, right. Nothing wrong with that.
Lady Dot? Hey, let me ask you a question.
Oh, what? No.
Are you available?
Am I available?
Are you single?
I'm single, but, you know, I'm not really looking for anyone right now.
Oh, yeah.
You're not looking for anything right now. You're
I'm not looking for anyone right now.
What?
I'm not looking for anyone right now.
What's wrong with Tippy Tom?
Huh?
What's Tippy Tom, good looking, man.
I didn't say anything was wrong with him.
Yeah, why are you knocking Tippy Tom there, Lady Dot?
I'm not knocking him.
I'm trying to get Tate over here.
With anyone
I'm
yet.
Right,
hey,
leave me alone.
All right, Tippy Tom, why don't you work your magic and talk to Lady Dot?
I can't say that on the air.
Hey, Lady Di.
Yes.
Can Tippy Tom use your stink spot for a finger cleaner?
I'm really trying to get.
Hold on, Tippy Tom. Hold on. Let's decide.
No, I'm trying to get some across. I'm talking to some
Jesus.
Chick.
Okay, you want?
Hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on.
I heard that. No.
Jesus. Don't say it again.
Tippy Tom, don't say it. He has needs, Anthony.
Don't say it, though. Yeah, you have needs. Let's just say that. Don't use that F word.
I have needs.
You have
I'm
needs.
A person.
Everyone has needs.
I'm a human being.
Oh, hold on, Tom. Turn that mic off on me. Hold on.
We've run out of dump now.
Tippy Tom, you can't use that word. Don't use that word anymore.
All right.
Yeah, don't use that one. That's a bad one.
Yeah, that is a bad one.
No more bad words.
No more bad words. You can't use that word. That's a bad word.
All right. You want some good words? You want some poetry?
No, not yet. Not yet. Until that dump light turns back on. Not yet.
You want to hear a joke?
Not yet.
Hold on. We'll get to it, though.
Yeah, we'll get to it.
You can tell me a joke if you want.
Shut up.
Lady Di, shut up.
He did it. All right.
Lady Di.
Yes.
We're going to suggest a few things.
We have an idea that will guarantee you will be a member of this program that you'll be able to come back on with.
Was it what I heard before?
Not exactly.
There could be a few things here.
Yeah, mm-hmm. there's a few things. Would you be up to tossing Tippy Tom's salad?
No.
No.
You're getting me in trouble, man. You're getting me arrested. You want to rob me?
Oh, man.
Well, okay. Well, you want to give her the one idea that I think might work?
All right, I'll work on that one.
Go ahead, Tippy Tom.
All right, who's next?
Who's next?
All right.
No.
Now I'm out of dump again. Wait a minute.
Hold on.
Jesus.
Shut him up. La, 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 la. Shut him
hold
up.
On. Hold
what
on.
What is the matter, Tippy Tom?
Shut up. He wants to know if Lady Dot will lick something on him.
His yam bag.
His yam.
No. No.
All right, Lady Di.
You're in trouble around here.
Lady Di, would you give Tippy Tom maybe a quick handy?
No.
No?
No. I heard some of those ideas before.
You could wear a glove.
No.
Lady Di, if you wear a glove mm-hmm. and give him a handy,
mm-hmm.
you will be able to continue being on this program.
No, I don't know if I want to do that. No.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
Because that's... No, I can't do
What's
that.
What's wrong with you?
Huh? There's nothing wrong with me. There's nothing wrong with me.
All right. How about this idea? How about this idea?
What's that?
You put on...
I sing to Tippy Tom?
You put on a strut.
Tippy Tom, don't talk right now.
Oh, all
right,
no,
is
Jesus.
That a good idea?
Wait, hold on.
Wait. Not yet. Don't talk yet.
Hold on. Stop. Shut him up.
What is he saying?
His language is
really bad.
Keith, shut him up. Oh, my God.
All right, Tippy Tom, take a break.
Bye.
He just started screaming, I want to F your A.
No.
Oh, no. My God.
Tippy Tom.
Any more ideas?
Here.
Wow.
All right. Lady Di.
Yes.
Here's the deal.
What's that?
You will strap on an appliance and service that man.
I don't know.
You're thinking about
how would I service him?
If you strap on an appliance,
he's a gay gentleman.
Okay.
And then, you know, you have to do the deed with the appliance.
Any more ideas?
No, it wouldn't be your actual skin though, because it's an appliance.
Right.
It's hygienic and it's not even actually a sexual
thing. Oh my God.
You wouldn't even be touching him.
Hmm.
You understand what I mean? There's nothing.
What is he yelling out there?
Why is he yelling out there?
I'm an old fashioned faggot.
Yeah. You get him out. Get him back on.
He's old school.
Lady Di.
Yes.
You gotta do something with Tippy Tom.
Your singing is horrendous, and it's not going to keep you on the show.
My singing's not that bad.
Breathing heavy.
Hey, I see John.
I'm not breathing heavy. I'm sitting down.
There he is.
All right, Tippy Tom, you're what? An old
fan.
Hold on.
Don't use the S word.
Keith, hold on.
Don't use that word.
We just ran out of more dump.
That's a bad word.
Hold on. Don't.
No more bad words.
Okay, thank you.
Right. No more bad words. Stop writing the bad words down.
We just want to know.
His foot.
Listen to what he's saying.
Tippy Tom, we just want to know. You're an old-fashioned faggot?
Is that what you said?
You're an old-fashioned faggot?
I'm a faggot. I was a faggot from 2 years old. Now, I tell you this right
now. Ever since 2 years old, huh?
Shut up, Lady
Di. I knew I was a faggot when I was 2 years old.
Oh, yeah?
How did you know?
Because I knew.
Lady Di, stop asking him questions.
Okay, all right.
I'm a queer. Now, you don't like queers? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Who?
Lady Di.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Take your balls and go somewhere else. Damn right I'm a queer. And I've been a queer. And they're right. And I'm for it. And that's right. Okay, so I'm queer.
Who cares, right? Who cares?
So what? I have girlfriends, too.
Hey, yeah. Hey, do you use protection there, Tippy Tom? You use the condoms?
Excuse me?
Do you use the condoms when you're doing
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I use... Well, I don't have...
Do you have the Ninja?
Not much lately. But, yes.
Are you afraid of getting AIDS, Tom?
You don't die of AIDS. You die of something else. You might get HIV... But you don't. I know people live 20 years old that don't have AIDS. You don't die of AIDS.
Dr. Tom.
You die of a cold.
Right. What happens is it makes it so other things kill you.
Your immune system.
Right.
Is down.
But so aren't you still, you might be afraid that if you keep having unprotected sex, you're going to get the AIDS.
You've got the AIDS, but it don't matter. You're not going to die of that. You're going to die of something else.
That is a rationalization I have not yet heard.
You know something?
Yeah. Living outdoors, don't you think you're going to get cold?
You walk down the street, you get shot in the head.
Right. What are you going to do?
If you're behind a dumpster, you can get shot in the face.
Yeah, right. And you're shot in the ass, that's even worse. Right.
Exactly.
You don't die of AIDS.
Right, but it kind of helps the other diseases kill you, though.
Exactly.
So aren't you afraid
you're
of maybe
right.
Aren't you afraid of maybe getting it and giving it to other people or something? I don't know.
I don't give it to other people. I'm obsessed with nobody.
You just said a week ago. I'll say it again.
Oh, man.
All right, hold on, Timmy.
Tom, you're a classic.
All right, Tom.
You sure is.
A classic.
We said you can't say that. You can say Hummer.
Yeah.
You know.
You're still,
You got a ring.
Yeah, yeah. You could still get the age from that, though.
Yeah. So what? You get hepatitis C.
Yeah.
Which I've had for 20 years.
Oh, Jesus.
You can't catch it from nobody. It just happens. You get it from food. They don't even know where you get it from. Your liver, you only got one liver. You got one heart. You got two eyes, two ears, two arms, two legs.
Actually, the liver is three lobes, which you can live with.
It could become.
You only got one liver. And yes, I got liver cancer.
How many feet do you have?
And that is what I've been going on with. And
you got the liver cancer there, Tippy Tom?
Yeah.
How'd you get that?
No, they put needles in my stomach to pull out pieces. But I know I'm going to live another 30 years.
Yeah?
Yeah. I told the doctor that.
You better stop drinking, hon.
Lady guys, tell Timmy Tom to stop drinking. Are you insane?
No, I mean, if he has something wrong with his liver, he shouldn't be drinking.
Lady Di, look in the mirror.
Yeah, take it easy, Lee Remick.
I'm fine.
Remick.
Drinking ain't had nothing to do with it.
No.
Right.
No. Drinking had nothing to do
Just keep drinking, Tom.
It's not from drinking.
That's what I say.
All right. Well, let's let Lady Di go. Lady Di, you're not going to do anything with Tippy Tom?
I don't think so.
I think the appliance is a good idea because you don't have to use anything
really. Yeah.
There's no skin-to-skin contact. The appliance is the best one. It's a strap-on type thing, and it's safe.
Well, we'll see, okay? You know, that's something for me to decide.
I hope he doesn't have tuberculosis.
I mean, you know.
What do you mean you need to decide? Do you need to sit down and talk with your family? Just do it.
No.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
I will think of something before I go on the show tomorrow.
That's the idea. I think that's the one, the thing. I think the little strap-on appliance is the best one.
Would you help me with that, Norton?
No, but it's not actually a sexual
lady.
Thing.
Lady!
What?
Come on, I'm on stage now. Lady!
Are you going to be... Guys, I will come up with something. Don't worry about it. Okay?
We are so out of dump. It's right. Ridiculous.
Tell Tom to take a break.
Hold on, Tom.
Tell Tom to take a break.
Tom, grab another beverage, man.
Yeah, go take a break.
We'll get you back in a minute. Grab a beverage.
Take a break.
You dropped something, Tom.
Can I have your face?
No.
Oh,
not
man.
At all.
All right.
God damn.
Well, Lady Di, good luck tomorrow.
Okay, I'll think of something. Don't worry about it.
Do you have any ideas as of now?
As of now, I have a few.
Well,
but
no,
I will definitely,
you don't. Stop
tomorrow.
Your friggin' lying. You're a lying sack.
No,
you don't have a few. We ask you, what are the other ideas? You say, I don't know. I got a few. You don't have anything. Well, tell us one other idea. Go.
One other idea. Yeah. Let me see. Acting out a scene in a movie? Or having a duet with Tippy Tom.
What scene are you going to act out? Is it the one where you bite off Bo Derek's leg?
Yeah, that one.
And besides, we can't get Richard Harris in here.
Maybe I'll sing a duet with Tippy Tom. How's that sound?
Oh, stop it. You're trying to be cutesy, wacky, and it's coming off stupid.
You know, and you secretly think you have talent. You secretly think you can sing.
I didn't say anything.
No, listen to me, little baby teeth. You secretly think
I don't
think
have baby teeth.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Lady Di, you better come up with something very outrageous for tomorrow.
I will.
What do you have so far? Nothing.
Norton, you don't know that. I might have something.
Then say it. What do you have? No one's. What's someone going to do? Steal it and make a sitcom out of it?
What do you have?
No.
What do you have? Say something. What do you have?
Well, like I said, I had the singing.
That doesn't involve your stupid voice. What do you have?
Okay. It doesn't involve my voice?
Singing. Yeah, it doesn't involve singing.
There's a few other things I'm thinking about
right
now.
No, there isn't.
Stop.
You're lying.
I am not lying.
Then tell us one. Tell us one.
Tell us one.
Let me see.
So you're just making it up as you go along?
Tell you one.
Tell you one.
An idea? And she's still, like, thinking, that little brain just smoking.
Yeah. I am smoking.
Come on, you little stegosaurus.
I mean, my brain is smoking right now. My brain's smoking.
Shut up.
What?
Come up with something.
Come on. What do you have? You lie. Why do you lie?
Come on. What do you got?
Well, I could also dance.
Would you do it in Hungary with, like, a little ring through your nose for tourists?
With the ring on my nose? No.
Wow.
Rings on my ears, yes, but not rings on my nose.
Well, Lady Di, it's going to be kind of sad when we say goodbye to you.
Wow. Yep.
Well, don't worry about it.
You know nothing. We gave you some pretty good ideas with Tippy Tom.
Yeah, stop thinking about what you can do to stay on the show. Just think about a farewell.
Tippy Tom going
to
be there tomorrow?
Think about a farewell speech, because you're done.
Is Tippy Tom going to be there tomorrow?
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter to you.
You said you wouldn't do anything with him.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Would you do
I mean, we have to see.
Would you do the butt chug?
No, I definitely wouldn't do that.
Why? It's easy.
No.
Let's do it!
I would not do that.
Let's do it!
That I would not do.
That I cannot
do. I'll think of something. Don't worry.
Tippy Tom is still alive.
We're actually not worried, Lady Di.
No one is worried.
Right, well, I will definitely think of something for tomorrow. Don't worry about
that. Let's do it!
Okay?
You haven't had anything, though.
We just wanted some interesting radio tomorrow before we kick your ass out the
door. Yeah, and we're not going
to
get it. I'm trying to help you,
and all you're saying is I could sing, well, I could dance. Look, you have no artistic ability. You're not going to sing and dance.
And this isn't Star Search.
You're not Shirley Temple.
I never said it was Star Search. I didn't say anything.
Who cares about singing and dancing?
Should we find a 70-year-old pickaninny you can sing with?
Well, I don't sing like that.
It's got to be something very outrageous.
All right, it's going to be something outrageous.
Like what?
Like what? Give me a little more time. I'll think of something.
A little more time. She's had a week and a half.
You've had your whole effing life to think things over. What good's a few minutes more going to do you now?
Bye-bye, Lady Di.
Bye-bye.
The clock continues to tick.
There it is. Bye-bye.
When do you think maybe Marion should go to a doctor?
Why is he pointing at me? What's your problem? What's wrong?
Don't bully him.
Well, why is he pointing at me? What did I do wrong?
He's
what?
He's in a blackout.
He wants his mic back. He wants the same.
Yeah. What's wrong?
What happened?
I thought I was going to get a beer. Now, where? There's no beer out here.
I'm going to get you a beer. Have a seat.
Wait. What? Yeah, next month?
Oh, there you go.
All right. Yeah, be more like him.
Tippy Tom.
Tippy Tom, come here.
Tippy Tom, sing your song before we go to break.
Yeah, Rod Stewart. You're not getting out of this beer.
What?
Do you have to talk to him?
Sing your Rod Stewart.
No, just sing your Rod Stewart.
What are your three choices?
My three choices of life?
You want to sing Rod Stewart?
You said you had three choices you were going to sing.
Oh, rock and roll? Or what category?
Pick, what are your three categories?
Look how calm he gets when he has a beer in his hand.
What category?
Yeah.
I left my heart, that comes to mind first, in San Francisco.
Left your colon in San Francisco.
Not to mention his T-cells.
It calls to me. Little cable cars. Now, who am I thinking about? Anybody got any idea?
San Francisco?
Tony Bennett.
What was his name before he was Tony Bennett?
Tippy Tom.
No.
No?
His name was Anthony Benedico. You know who gave him his name?
Wow. I'll assume his parents.
No. Bob Hope said, you ain't Anthony Benedico no more. You are Tony Bennett. Yeah. Bob Hope
You know who he is?
Of course.
That's how we got his name.
Thanks for the memories. That guy, Bob Hope. Yeah. Yeah, sing.
Sing.
As we go to break, Tippy Tom.
Sing us out.
Little angel.
All right, let me belt one out here.
Belt one out. Rock and roll.
Some rock and roll.
Some rock and roll.
Okay.
Let's go.
English or American?
You pick.
All right. Hey, if you want my body and you think I'm sexy, come on, baby, let me know.
Woo!
Diet. Boom, 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 boom.
Who did that? Rod Stewart.
Yes.
Yeah!
Your stomach has something in common with his.
All right, wait a minute now. Too easy.
All right. Why don't you take a break, Tippy Tom? All right, Tom. Okay. Go out, enjoy your... Oh, you got another?
Give me a song.
All right, give us another song. Give us another song.
I got plenty of songs.
Well, give us one.
I love music. All right. Okay. Let me think. I'm thinking right now. Okay. Okay. Tippy Tom, thinking.
Uh-oh.
Okay, something that you might get.
Yeah.
If I go way back, you're not going to get it.
Tom, just sing anything right now.
I want you all in the club, because I tell you right now, being be out of the club, you can't guess this one here.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, rock and roll, 60s stuff.
Right. 60s stuff, go ahead.
All right,
let's roll.
I'm out of the club. No, okay, all right, wait.
Go ahead.
No.
Here we go.
English band, okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, I'm out of the club.
You can't curse like that, Tippy Tom.
Right, wait, no.
No more cursing.
All right.
Hurry up, we got to take a break.
I'm going to get hard and nasty.
All right, let's rock. Yeah. Go ahead.
We're going to get down American.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Riders on the Storm. Boom. You got it?
Yeah. Is there anything
Where's
you know
rest?
More than three words to?
No. Riders on the Storm. He might know.
Into
the Doors.
Come on, let's go.
What?
It's the Doors, but it's...
He got it!
Yeah, but we want you to sing it. It's not a contest.
He know right away!
We're not playing Trivial Alcoholism.
Y'all out of the club. He in the club. Y'all out of the club.
All right.
You want some more rock and roll?
No, why don't you take a break?
We're going to take a break.
Mm-hmm. All right, Tippy Tom, wait outside. Enjoy your beer.
Oh! I'm out here singing right now.
We're
going to
come back.
Enjoy your beer there, Tippy Tom. We'll have you back in.
He dropped something.
Thank you, bro.
John Valby's outside the studio, horrified. Absolutely horrified.
Holy and we got to get the girls in.
Listen
next.
To this spray. Ben is spraying everything. Oh, my God. All right, Ben, that's going to totally.
Easy, Howard Hughes.
I don't blame him.
Bugs. They creep up on you.
Yeah. All right.
Bugs. All right, we'll break and we'll try to get out of this tailspin next.
Opie and Anthony.
A bunch of perverted crackers.
Oh, what? It's hard to listen to us trying to talk teen girls into doing stuff with each other?
The Opie and Anthony Show.
What a mess today. Yes. Who knows how this sounds today? It's the Opie and Anthony Show. I'll tell you one thing, a lot of observations going on. John Valby's here, and he's hiding behind a corner.
I know.
Outside the studio. I thought Tippy Tom would be a lot like the audience that John gets. I've been to a lot of his shows. The audience seems to be a lot like Tippy Tom, especially by the last couple of tunes.
Yeah, they're a little drunker, and their blood is unhealthier.
Let's get John Valby in here. Tom, what's going on?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I just wanted to tell you congratulations for having such a big star like Al Pacino is today.
Yeah, wow. He does sound like Al Pacino.
Dude.
Either Al Pacino or George Carlin. Little George Carlin in it.
Sean, what's going on?
Yo, what's up, boys?
Hey.
Yo, before when he was singing, he goes, you want to hear it in English or American? What's the difference? Yeah. Hey, where's my poo-poo bear, Norton?
Hi, sugar bear.
Hey, buddy.
Poo-poo bear.
Johnny, love out, boys.
All right, bye. Here comes John Valby into the studio.
All right. There he is. Dr. Dirty himself, John Valby.
You all right, John?
How you doing, John?
You all right?
Howdy, yeah.
You looked a little nervous out there.
Oh, my God. That's a scary thing. I do this for fun. You know, this guy's for real.
Yeah, he's for real.
I wrote a little thing about him, though.
You did?
Yeah, let's see if the piano's on. And
I don't know if it's working yet.
Oh, it is.
Oh, no, wait. We got one.
We got one channel.
We got one channel.
Hold on.
Yeah, we need another. We're only getting it through one ear. All right. Rick, anything? Now there's no ears.
That's good.
That's good.
My God, what
good work, Rick. That's all right. It's called a sound check. Yeah. Anything? No.
Just go to the left mono, yeah.
Oh.
Okay, put the other one in the mono. Yeah.
Anything there? I hear a hum. I hear a buzz.
That is.
Hey, Rick, maybe you could
break
his hand.
Maybe we should have settled for one side.
Yeah, Rick, just break his hands.
Good work. Yeah. Good work, Rick.
Oh, there it is. That's more than enough.
Oh, here's Pete Johnson.
Hold on, Pete.
Pete will hook you up in a second. This guy, he used to be a roadie in vaudeville.
Pete, vaudeville there?
Pete,
vaudeville.
What seems to be the problem today?
It's only coming out of the phone, Jack, I think.
Why is it only in one ear, Pete? Okay, Pete looks at it. He gets that look in his eye, that engineer look. Okay, I'm assessing the problem.
He's looking it over. He's going to have an answer soon, Anthony.
It's just in one ear, but...
He's still deciphering.
Radio is mostly mono, isn't it?
Yeah, back in the 50s.
Come on.
Wait, don't even. It stinks.
All right, Pete, what do you think?
What do you think, Pete?
What do you think, Pete?
Pete fixes this.
Huh?
I don't know what to
do. Send it out in mono there, Pete.
Yeah, why don't we do a little mono action?
That's all you got to do. Just send it through.
You mono
it on the board.
All right, why don't we do that? We just go do a little of this here.
Oh, there you go.
See? Yeah. Let's try that.
Damn, Pete, I should get your job now. There we go.
Hey, well, want to try this Tippy Tom one?
Let's try one for Tippy Tom.
He just wrote this.
His name is Tippy Tom, and he's a drunken effing dork. He's probably taking a dump on every corner in New York. His teeth are kind of hairy. His brain no longer thinks. And an hour after he leaves, the room still effing stinks.
There you go.
A little too close to reality, though.
Yeah, just a tad.
Yeah, John Valby.
He's having fun out there, though. He's been, you know, what else does he want in life? A little beer,
company. A little attention, you know?
Right. And there's some very attractive girls out there that he could look at, even though I don't think he's into girls as much as the guy.
He's too busy looking at us, Anthony. Yeah.
Oh, is that? What's his us stuff?
Yeah, it's you. Your blonde locks.
Yeah.
Your chin.
Gay men do not like me.
They don't like me.
Oh, stop it.
They do.
You can be all man, but still be attractive to gay gentlemen.
I don't want to hear that.
Yeah, nice circular look.
I don't want to hear that.
You
see the way Mario Cantone looks at you?
He asked Rick. He goes, Rick, you work out? Yes.
Rick's another one. The gay people love Rick.
All right.
Whether it's that little picture of him all skinny in junior high or the Rick of now.
No, they don't like the Ralph Macchio Rick. They like this Rick.
They like the muscle-bound Rick.
Well, that's from my high school senior year, dude.
Get out of here. Oh, I thought that picture. It's up on foundrymusic.com, and people have they put it on the captionizer. So people have been writing captions. And one that got me laughing was next week on Degrassi Junior High.
You look like a kid.
That was your senior year of high school?
That was my senior year, yeah.
The last year of your beatings from everyone in school?
Basically, yeah.
Brutal. And then he decided to do some roids, and now look at him. He can walk around the locker room of the gym naked.
Now he's got old hustlers trying to pick him up.
Tippy Tom's an old old-fashioned faggot. That's what he says.
He was a hustler, back in the day in San Francisco, and then somehow he found his way here to New York. And
I heard him trying to do that song. I thought it went, high on some pills, I lost control. He's not your average Tinkerbell. He'll make the studio smell beyond your wildest dreams.
You can't say that.
That's all right.
Hey, John, where are you playing tonight? A lot of people
are Danbury, Tuxedo Junction tonight.
Very nice.
And Rascals tomorrow night. And next Thursday, Mulcahy's.
On Long Island.
Yes.
We might do the Mulcahy's show with
him. Hell yeah. That'd be great.
You want to get the girls in here too, Anthony?
Yeah, let's bring some of the girls help us out.
It's already a cluster F. Might as well get Tippy Tom in here too.
Oh, brother.
Thanks, Keith.
Let's find out about the girls first.
Yeah.
Not going to be able to get a word in edgewise.
Edgewise.
Where are they? Rick's having such a difficult time getting people in and out of this studio.
Hey, can you tell the porno chicks to stop arguing physics?
Yeah, that must be the delay.
Hey, Rick.
Oh, I swear.
Rick, what's the problem? What's the problem?
One of them dropped the drill.
Oh, these are the drill girls from D.C.
That's right.
Oh, boy.
Hey, ladies. They got some of those...
Hey, are you guys entering our WOW contest?
No.
Yeah.
Are we? Wow.
Yeah?
Yeah, okay. If you want to.
Wow, they have...
Hello, how are you?
They have some Ryobi drills, the cordless drills with attachments on them. Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Look at Norton wants to kill himself. Norton wants to kill himself because you're so attractive.
Oh, really?
That's what he does.
Well, don't do that now. I mean, if you kill yourself, then I'm not going to be able to, you know, please you, make you happy.
Oh, boy.
I can show you what I can do.
And what she can
do.
It's amazing. The drill with the attachment on it.
I brought the drill dough. I love it.
The drill dough.
I get so much pleasure from it.
Do you really? Do you really?
Look at this. This is awesome. Wow. Now, hold on. You can't buy this at Home Depot, so...
No, not that part of the attachment.
You're the drill.
And it spins around.
But it shakes and spins. When you do that, do you hold up a picture of Michael J. Fox?
Hold on. Hold on. I got the idea.
Watch.
Tippy Tom. Get Tippy Tom in here.
Oh, no. You are bad. No.
Get Tippy Tom. Get him in here for a second.
You are the worst human being.
Get Tippy Tom in here.
If you use that on him, it's going to look like a Texas oil thing.
Gusher. She's a gusher.
Crap's going to be flying all over the studio.
Oh, God.
One of those old sitcoms where the blender explodes with the chocolate shake. It goes all over the walls. Hey, Tippy Tom.
Oh, I could use one of those.
Oh, God, no.
He already likes it, Anthony.
You like it?
You got the drill? The batteries work? Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, well, you like it. How do you like it?
I like the way it was going.
Hey, Tippy Tom, would you like
it? Use it?
Yeah. Well, we can't use it right here.
Okay. I see what you mean. But do you like this for your personal pleasure also?
I have no problem with
Tippy
that.
Tippy Tom, you want to try it out a little bit?
Yeah.
That's not fair. I'm a man.
This is mine.
Hey, Tom. Yeah. Tom.
No, you have to get your own. Drill.
No, my brother. You got to buy your own.
I know.
So Tippy Tom. She doesn't want you using it.
I thought you were going to share.
My girlfriend here.
How about that?
Oh, yeah.
They might not like the graphic depiction.
Yes.
There you go. So now, what do we want to do? Do we want the girls to demonstrate? Maybe Tippy Tom can watch? Or?
Our demonstration.
All right.
We'll describe. You guys do.
Yeah, you guys just do. Okay. Yeah, yeah. She looks at Tippy Tom. You can't touch us.
Tippy Tom.
Yeah, Tippy.
Tippy Tom back on.
Keith, move Tom back, but Keith, don't get him too close to John either.
Figure out what's going on.
Stand upwind.
All right. You have to be naked first.
All right, well, there they go. They're getting...
All right, they're...
They're getting ready.
All right.
Very, very
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, just pull all that, those pesky clothes.
Ooh.
Look at that, Jimmy.
Oh, it's lovely.
Beautiful. There you go. Wow. Oh, my goodness.
All right. Hey, Tippy Tom, what do you think?
I don't know.
Look how nice and clean these girls are, Tom.
Tom, get over there for a second.
Wow.
Get Tippy Tom on the mic. Tippy Tom.
Grab that mic, Tom. That's pretty good, huh?
All right, what I'm doing over here is I'm observing.
Gee whiz.
I'm observing something.
What are you observing?
I ain't quite got it figured out. What I'm trying to figure out is this.
Yeah, Tom?
What I'm observing.
All right, what are you observing?
Is that I'm not quite observing what I'm figuring out.
Now, Tom, those are,
they seem to be missing something, huh, Tom?
I'm not sure what's going on over here. But what I'm thinking is what's going on is somebody just hanging out. And that's what I'm thinking right now.
Tom, do you like Tom, do you like what you see?
Without a doubt. what I'm saying, but I ain't quite figured it out
now,
yet.
Tom, whatever you do, don't describe anything that you're seeing, please.
I don't know nothing.
Leave that to the professional.
I know nothing.
Wow.
All right, Tom.
I just want to
Jimmy,
see what's going on.
Why are you looking at
here?
The camcorder? Look at what's in front of you.
I can't get in there. I got to look through the camcorder.
All right, Tom. See what
anyway,
you
anyway, I better get out.
Oh, the mic just got shut off.
I'm not old enough.
What's wrong, Tippy Tom?
His hand's on the button, I think.
Oh, Tom.
Tom, lift your hand off the mic button.
Yeah, get your hand off the counter.
Oh, wow. All right, they are just preparing, getting ready.
Yeah.
Wow. Tom, take a look, man.
It's not a shaver, it's a microphone, you idiot. We're hitting him a microphone and he thought it was a shaver.
Take a look, Tom, just take a look. When he went to go grab,
Hey, Tom, what's wrong? Why are you leaving?
I'll be back later.
Why? What's wrong?
Oh, no, don't let him go into the bathroom alone.
Carter.
All right, what happened to Tom?
Where did Tom go? Did he grab her leg? The guy's out of his mind.
You're an expert, baby.
Wow. You know, I never remember using my drill quite that way when I was in the tin knocking business. We had the cordless drills and never saw that attachment. Look how nice they are to each other.
Yeah,
there's kissing and all kinds of nurturing going on between these ladies.
Wow. Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, if it stuck, couldn't it just... like, doesn't it have to...
You picture her just spinning around?
Spinning around. Flop, 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 flop. Does that build up any heat or friction? Wow. Yeah?
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy, Jim says.
I'm going to last 5 seconds.
Yeah.
You like that?
It's like an indie pit stop. Look at him go. Tom starts going over toward Opie and Ben, and they fled.
Tom, I think he wants Opie to use the drill on him.
Easy.
Baby, come on.
Hey. What do you think, Tom? That was something, huh?
Hey, Tom, what did you think?
What did you think, Tom?
Stop it. I gotta get out of here.
Oh, you love it, baby. You know you love it.
I think Tom's getting a little embarrassed.
But I'm not ready.
Tom, are you getting embarrassed?
I'm not ready right now. I'm not ready.
No, he's not.
No?
No, he defecates in public.
Yeah, but I think this is making him a little...
He's not embarrassed.
He's a little freaked out.
He's a little freaked out. Yeah.
Exactly.
Is he going into the bathroom, you think?
He's going to make sure all of us die of a cold by the time he leaves here.
Oh, yeah. Just
sleep,
baby.
All right, well, this is wonderful. Oh, come on, turn that camera a little bit.
I can't even see.
Rick.
Look at the stinky cam, it's on teeth.
Yeah, I know.
That's disappointing.
Let's see how much we can get there.
Three hot lesbians and you're looking at
teeth. All right,
teeth.
Put it down a little. Aim it down a little. Hold on, let's see.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good, right there.
Yeah.
Right there, beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Such nurturing going on between these girls. Look at this one's taking care of the top section.
I know.
That one's doing other things. Isn't that wonderful? They work as a team, Opie.
I see that.
They work as a team all together.
Oh, yeah.
And Tippy Tom, uh-oh. Rick just came in with some kind of emergency with Tippy Tom and sent Keith running out of the studio.
He ran down the hall.
Rick, what happened with Tom?
I think he decided to leave the building or something. He's gone.
He can't take this. See, I think he is. Like, he can't take this girl-girl action. Wow.
Very nice.
What do you think, Jim? Nice?
Without aesthetically, one of them.
Well, the girls just wanted to come by and say hi, Andy.
Yeah.
There they are. They're beautiful. Mika, Pamela, and Ashley from 2Exposed.com.
Amazing.
And if you would like to check us out and look at our website also, you can check out pornodan.com and check out On the Air is where you can see more of our photos.
Yeah.
Pornodan.com.
Yeah.
All right. And you guys are in town for the orgy thing?
Yes. We had a great time.
Oh, it happened already?
Yeah, it was last night.
How was Vanessa Del Rio? Was she there?
Did Rick do a good job?
Did Rick go? Yeah, Rick was,
Yeah, we saw him.
What's the matter, Rick? You're not going to tell us how it was? He's too busy taking pictures.
Yeah, he's taking pictures. Occupied.
Yeah, remember him taking pictures.
He didn't even mention it.
Yeah, what happened there, Rick?
How dare you? Oh, yeah, see, he doesn't want to speak right now.
Why don't we get a picture, all three of you, completely naked?
Yeah, all right. The girl's getting naked. We'll break, Anthony. Go to pornodan.com to check out the lovely ladies, okay?
All right.
Also in the studio, John Valby. We'll have him do a few ditties for us next.
Uh-huh.
What a crazy day today is, man.
Some days, you know, we're a laugh riot, and other days we just flat out suck. We know it.
Interesting and true.
Opie and Anthony.
A couple of phone numbers in the New York area, 877-692-1027. Outside of New York City, 866-277-4. Wow. We had three beautiful women in the studio, three blondes. You can go to pornodan.com and check them out for yourself. Doing some crazy stuff, and then Tippy Tom ran out. He couldn't take it, Anthony.
Yeah.
And he left the building, but now he's back, and Keith the Cop is here with an explanation. What's up, Keith?
We just overloaded him. He couldn't take it anymore.
He couldn't take the visual he was getting.
He said it's too much. He needed to get out.
He leaned over and touched one of the girl's legs, I guess?
Yeah.
Oh, man, they must have loved that.
He was freaking out downstairs. Security didn't even want him back in the building.
I think the other mic's working, and no one really cares. There you go.
Oh, well.
Poor Tom, though. He's been living outdoors for a long time. Things aren't going well. Then you got these three. I mean, I see girls like this in studio, and I want to whack my bag on the floor. How do you think he feels?
Well, he I don't know if he digs the chicks, though.
He dug the chicks.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's yeah, that or Opie in his red hat. He looks so boyish with the blonde
Stop.
Hair.
Stop!
Like you've been rollerblading.
This show is so gay. Stop.
I'm just speculating. You had a little thing tied
Enough
around
with
the neck.
The gay stuff.
We just sexed it up a little bit, and you're going to bring us right back
I'm
into the gay
saying,
zone.
You got a little color. Maybe he wants to kiss you on the cheek.
Stop.
You know?
Holy
Jesus.
Jeez.
John Valby in the studio.
Yeah. Well, I can get it back to whipping your Skippy over there.
I hope so.
But when I'm feeling blue, I whip out my Magoo and rub its little head until the head goes and gives my thumb a bath. Wouldn't you agree? My Magoo and me have a handy kind of love.
Oh, no.
All right, I forgot.
No.
I forgot what happens when John Valby's in the studio. We get to play them the next day.
I forgot. Can someone check to see if we...
Oh, all those were good words.
No, they were.
Yeah.
They were good.
You know something?
I forgot.
You would have been right probably 2 years ago.
Stinky three dumps?
Yeah.
We've gotten so screwed lately. Even worse than the first time you came in.
Wow.
It's even worse because people have this morality that they like to pour on and tell the FCC.
Well, let's try another one.
All right.
It's John Valby.
Oh,
His name is Robert Blake. And after he shot his wife, he should have hid the gun where O.J. hid the knife. Unless he hires Johnny Cochran, he's going to the slam. The name of his new tune will be Big Bubba, You the Man. How about, oh, her name is Britney Spears. And if she's a virgin, I'm a priest. Her box is still leaking NSYNC's bunk, but for Rosie, that's a feast. That slutty little tramp has Ellen's weasel on her face. But if she did Jeff Gordon, he might win another race. Come on, one more. Oh, his name is Mike Tyson. And here's the effing deal. Everyone who gets in the ring with me, I treat like a happy meal. I bite their ears, I bite their legs, I give their a ribbon. But after last fight, I'm going back to beating women.
I made it. I think most of that made it, right?
Yeah.
I hope so.
Right? Stinky, could he report for us?
He'll come running in with his thumbs down. No.
All that made it?
Yeah. Sure. Wow. Yeah. All
right.
Hi.
I've been editing.
Yeah.
Sure you have, John.
How about Agent Scully's bush is covered with crop circles?
Well, that's okay.
Here's a New York one. Your sister went to my crotch to watch the ball drop. How about your sister played dead till the dog was done?
Oh, that's, yeah. Well,
I don't know. I like that. How about the old man told your sister it was pudding?
Yeah, that's fine.
How about Grandma ran over her nipple with her wheelchair?
What is wrong? That's great.
How about your mother can stall a lawnmower in her bush hair?
Uh-oh. Stinky.
Oh, no, Stinky. Which one?
Stinky came in all dejected. How many dumps?
Just one. I think it was the bus seat.
Yeah, that's
really?
What I thought. Yeah.
You can't?
For some reason, you can't say the F word for the gas thing.
What? No way.
Kidding.
No, that's not true.
I'm telling
Maybe
you.
Maybe it's the S-U-C-K word.
Maybe no, that's it.
Nope, I guarantee no. It's the F word for the gas.
Are you kidding
you
me?
You can't say that on the radio?
He dumps out every time we say it.
Fart!
You can't say that?
Oh, what a baby, sweater vest boy.
Can't say that?
I'm sure Stinky will let us know if that made it. Did that make it? That didn't make it?
No.
Well, maybe.
Oh.
Oh, boy. Wow.
I'm trying so hard.
These people.
How about your grandma's face took a direct hit from the mule?
Yeah, okay, that'll make it. What?
Wait,
your grandma's face?
No, two before that.
Oh, no. Stop it.
Garrett.
All right, thank you, Garrett.
Hi,
Garrett. Thank
you. We got to wait for our delay to build up a little. We must sound like we're underwater again. Damn.
You have a clean one over there, John?
You know, I got one. I just played in Texas last night at my old fort, Fort Hood, Texas. And anyway, and with the Paul McCartney marriage thing, a limerick, you know. It kind of relates to Texas, too. I don't know. You want to try it? I've never tried it before.
Sure.
It goes, when Heather McCartney goes to bed, she unscrews it. And Sir Paul finds it hard to refuse it. And why can't he stop? To paraphrase ZZ Top, she's got leg. And she knows how to use it.
I'm going home early.
What's the matter, Opie?
I'm going home early.
I mean, you guys started the show with kicking people in the nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then this Tom guy, I mean, man.
I can't
say the F-A-R-T word.
Isn't that ridiculous?
I don't even think you could spell it.
Oh.
Well,
the FCC is disgraceful.
People are saying that Jimmy Norton actually said it and they heard it.
Wow.
Because he just said it.
Maybe if you use
no
it
context.
In any way, shape, or form.
Boy, why don't you button up your vest and run in and explain why we can't say that.
Hey, Tippy Tom.
Oh. Hey, what I'm saying is this.
Oh, is that Mike on?
Tom. He got a headache right now.
Tom, say.
He
want to
sit down.
Tom, say hoo-ah.
Yeah.
Hoo-ah.
Ozzy. All right. What I'm saying is this. Is that I want to kind of like take back 5 minutes by myself. You got a problem with that? Say, guys doing? What the hell y'all doing over here?
Tom, have you, how many beers you
messing
have?
Messing up with Tippy Tom. Tippy Tom, want to go downstairs?
Yeah.
He be bugging me. I'm going to sit downstairs.
Hey, Tippy Tom from New Orleans, did you like the girls?
Yeah, without a doubt.
You like the show they were putting on?
I
like
the
nice.
Guys, too.
Hey, we're getting a request for John Velvey.
Do you think he's cute?
Shut up!
He's a good-looking guy.
That's all right. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe see where he could have
got to get to know him a little better.
He got to get to know you.
What do you think of Jim Norton? What do you think of him over there?
Look, I've been a faggot for years. Now, what I'm saying is this. That yes, he's a very handsome, cute man.
He is, right? Opie is.
So are you.
Thank you.
So are you.
Jim Norton. Oh, he likes Keith, too,
and
huh?
And all them good-looking girls, too.
What about Ant?
Now, what I'm saying is this.
What about Ant?
Is I want to go downstairs and sit in there. He won't show me a way to get the hell out of here.
Why do you want to? Hey, we gave you beer and stuff and want you to hang out.
I just want to sit down by myself.
Oh, is that it?
All right.
Is too many people?
What is wrong with that?
Too many people hanging around, maybe getting you a little...
Yeah, I just let my head settle.
You got to unwind a little.
All them chicks down there, naked. What do you got?
No, wait a minute. All right, hold on. Hold on. All right.
All right.
All right.
Bye, Tom. Tom, have fun.
Hey, we're getting requests for John Valby's songs. Someone wants you to do the Bin Laden song that we were playing like crazy on our show.
What the hell happened to this
thing? A little drum.
Yeah. We got to figure out how to make this go back.
This is unbelievable.
This is one of those days.
This whole show is drunk.
I don't know.
Did you buy this on the way over?
This is your piano.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, this is your keyboard. Remember, it didn't work in the beginning? This, yeah.
All right, let's get Pete back in here. Because now all it's doing is, are you hitting the
rim shots?
Listen, he's just making drum sounds.
Right, let's do it a cappella. The mother is a knothead. The father is a pothead. The kids are all just poop heads. The Osborne family. Da 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 da. Oh my God.
His piano is now just set as a percussion instrument.
Steve's trying to figure it out. Tippy Tom has to go, Anthony.
He had to leave?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
We come from Alabama, but we're in Afghanistan. Where Navy SEALs and Green Berets hunting for a man. They say he has a bearded face, a diaper on his head. I heard we won't be going home until that effer's dead. Oh, Bin Laden, no, don't you die too quick. I come to F your fanny with some anthrax on my junk. When Osama's finally captured, let's not cut off his dork. Let's handcuff both his testicles and drag him to New York. There we'll contact firemen, turn on a power hose. Screw it to his sphincter till the comes out his nose. Oh, Bin Laden, no, don't you die too quick. I've come to F your fanny with some anthrax on my stick. At prison food, we'll probably give him gas. So instead, let's launch a bunker buster up his na-na-na. Oh, IF and make me gag. You're like 10 pounds of camel in a
9 pound
Believe everything got through. You did a fine job of self-editing yourself.
That one made it.
All
yes,
right.
Everyone's giving a thumbs up.
All right.
Thumbs up, Stink? All right.
Okay. Very good.
Wow. You know, I'm...
Ben looks like he's been through a war. You all right, Ben? Just taking it all in? Okay, I'm just checking.
What's the matter, Ben?
All right.
I'm really glad I flew up from Texas for today. You know, this is like a memoir day.
Well, it happens. You know, sometimes this place is like an insane asylum.
We might be setting the dump record today.
Oh yeah, with Tippy Tom and then
with the Tippy Tom, John Valby and three lesbians doing what they were doing. Oh yeah.
I bet there was some entertainment, though.
Well, I sure hope so. I don't think anybody described what the girls were doing this time. Thank God, except for Tom. Tippy Tom, reaching over and touching. Oh, I hope they get all kinds of AIDS tests.
Ooh,
just being touched.
He's walking.
Did you see his fingernails?
He's walking around the studio with Lysol.
Oh, Ben, you can't spray too much of that, though.
Yeah, but you want to.
It gets really bad.
I think John Valby has one more in him.
Do you got another
or
one?
A few more, right?
Oh, I don't know.
He's disgusting.
You know, the one I'd really like to do. Is that Boston one? No pedal. And Father Pedophilia picks up a kid in a vestibule after the mass, christens his ass. Later that evening, corners an altar boy in the confessional booth. Baptizes his tooth. All those Catholic perverts, where do they all come from? All those church donations pumped up some young boy. Cardinal denial transfers the priest to a parish that's right down the street. It's full of fresh meat. Bishop McBugger passing communion with one hand still under his frock. Pounding his... All those pervert clerics, let's throw them in the clink. All those Irish Catholics, no wonder why they drink.
Oh my goodness.
Bravo!
Hey.
I'm just waiting for the thumbs up from Stinky. I think most of that made the air.
Really?
Yes, I think so.
Great.
What, you're thinking one dump?
I don't know. I'm thinking one dump.
Thumbs
wow.
up!
Wow.
Yes! We're doing better.
God bless the FCC.
Wow, look at that.
Very nice.
Glad that went through.
Now, John, where are you playing again tonight? In Danbury, right?
Danbury, Tuxedo Junction. Tomorrow in Rascals. West Orange. And then next Thursday, Mulcahy's.
Long Island. I love when John makes it out to Long Island.
Oh, yeah.
There's some sick crowds out there, man.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Rocking it.
You going to stick around for a little more or what?
Well, I really should
you want
get,
out,
get
of
up the road.
I should leave. Leave your piano that doesn't work, and
I should leave with my dignity and get the hell out of here.
It was a very interesting afternoon.
We can't do the gangbang song. Jesus. What, people request songs that
you can't do the gangbang?
No, I don't think we'd be able to get away with the gangbang. Are there any that you believe we could get away with?
Let me see.
I like when he does something with all our names and stuff.
Oh, you mean the Hey Lotties?
Yeah, that's fun. You want me to write a few down
sure,
for you?
Write a few names and...
All right, and maybe we go out with this. Give me a pen there.
All right. Hey Lottie. Hey Lottie. Hey Lottie, Lottie, Lottie. Hey Lottie, Lottie, Lottie. Hey Lottie, Lottie, Lottie. I know a guy, his name is Tom.
Hey Lottie, Lottie, Lottie.
Right now. Didn't make it. You can't do that.
No, they don't like the that C word for product.
Oh,
yeah, they get really.
Yeah
look at Stinky comes in with the thumbs down.
Even Stinky at this point looks like a beaten man.
What they do? I know a guy. His name is Stinky.
Body locks.
Tom Shunk's the size of his little pinky. I know a guy. His name is Ben.
Hey, Lottie, Lottie.
on his sister since she was 10. What are you laughing at?
I know.
You know, we're just going to get me in big trouble. I don't want to get... Oh, man.
Yes.
Yeah, you know, it's just, if you can't say the real thing, it's just disappointing.
Isn't it?
It is. And
a bunch of people with their stupid morality. Ugh.
Hey. Fake.
People want us to spell your last name, Valby, V-A-L-B-Y.
That's it.
All this stuff all over the internet.
Yeah.
The real versions.
Yes, the real versions. And you got to see them live, because that's a party and a half, man.
Yeah.
A
lot of beers. How many CDs do
you have out? Oh, probably 15, 16, 17.
Correct.
Pick them all up at the live shows. You have them available there. And then at the end of the show, one of my favorite things, when you bring the girls up to help sing on stage.
Oh, yes. Barnacle Bill the Sailor.
Barnacle Bill, and they give the whole crowd a little show. Yes, it's
kind of like you had your own Barnacle Bill here today, only they can't see it.
Yeah, really.
Well, we'll have pictures.
Well, yeah, we got some great video of Tippy Tom.
Okay.
Well, for everybody
we
to
gotta leave
enjoy.
We got to leave on a high note.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to leave on a downer. Yeah. You know. Twinkle.
You can't say that word?
No.
Hold on. Jesus.
That is actually one of the seven deadly words there.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God.
And it started off so nice, John. It was so...
Can I say whiz?
Brought me right back to...
Whiz?
Can I say whiz? Whiz? It depends what you're going to say after you say that.
Twinkle.
Try.
Twinkle stream of whiz. All my beers have come to this. Bubbles in the parking lot. Little rivers steaming hot. Twinkle, twinkle, left and right. Tippy Tom whizzing in the effing night.
I think that was good, Stinky.
Can we confirm it?
Whiz.
Come to this.
Come to this. I see some people shaking their heads.
No.
Out. I don't know. Are we going to get the official word?
Confirmation is...
Here he comes.
Here he comes. He's walking around.
Oh, thumbs up.
Yes. Thumbs up.
Wait, no. Stinky's giving a thumbs down.
What?
Wiz didn't make it?
Which one didn't?
What? You missed it.
This dump is going down, so there was a dump in the last...
Don't get feisty with me, young man.
That guy in the hidden room over there.
Look at Stinky. He's a beaten man. He's getting all pissed off at us.
Oh, well. What are you going to do? All right. Well, I guess that's... can we do anything else?
He's looking at his notebook.
I your mother holds the record at the clinic. Yeah. She makes money down on her knees.
Uh-huh.
After she's finished, she sneezes. So what's one more airborne disease?
Stop! Well,
it's not going to get the big finish, though.
Yeah.
It was a cute little rhyme, and it probably made the air.
Isn't it so frustrating?
Oh, whole little town of Bethlehem. No, that won't make it.
I love the thought process that goes into this.
Yeah.
Because if you see his act, you know that there's a little chance of any of it making the air.
Yeah.
But he's just a good guy to have around. Then we present him in his, the light that he is.
I love watching him sweat, though, as he tries to figure it out.
Let's turn to the pages.
Oh, no. Just got home from all those happy faggots down in cell block 4. They banged me in the shower. Must have took an hour. But there's goo, 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 goo.
I bet you. Stinky, what's the verdict?
No.
Come on.
Three dumps.
Oh.
Three dumps.
Forget it.
Forget it.
Well, John, I appreciate the fact that you come in and
just
give
it
a try.
Just take our word for it. John Valby, very funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was funny.
Oh, that was really funny.
Ah,
I like how it's fizzing.
And there's
goo goo.
God. Bastards.
Oh, they didn't let goo goo goo?
Well, it was because where it was.
is what, you know, the whole. If you take the whole song as a whole, then there's a problem. Literally.
Yeah, there's a lot of problems.
God damn. Well, John, you know, hey, I mean, thank you for coming giving it that try best, like you know? You always do.
Yeah.
You're a trooper when it comes to this. And go see him live so you know what the hell you're missing on this show.
Danbury tonight, Rascals tomorrow night,
yeah,
and Mulcahy's next Thursday on Long Island. John Valby.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I think.
There will always be retarded idiots to entertain us with their stupidity.
Mindless crotch grabbing Anthony. People grabbing their crotches and saying, suck it. Okay, Anthony show. Suck it.
Love the show.
Mindless.
This is the Opie and Anthony Show. We're up to 31 dumps for the program today, Anthony.
31 times the show has been dumped out of today.
Does anyone know the record for the Opie and Anthony Show? It's got to be close to that, huh?
You think it was in the 50s,
in the
Rick?
50s.
I think it's in the 50s. I think I have the sheet back in the office.
Oh,
wow.
I think it was a two-sheeter that day.
A couple phone numbers in the New York City area. 877-692-1027. Anywhere else, 866-277-4-WOW.
In front of me, Opie, I have up a picture from the WNEW website here in New York. I guess anyone else can just go to opieandanthony.com. And it is a picture of a contestant, our first contestant from the Best WOW contest.
The only contestant so far.
Our only contestant.
What about all those pictures we brought back from Boston? Colombo's not here today to put them up.
No,
right?
He's putting them up right now.
Oh, he is putting them up. Okay.
I was going to say, if no one else enters, she wins $5,000.
Well, the lady's got a few weeks to get in on this, obviously. But you can see our first contestant. What's her name?
Tiffany.
She's beautiful from Sacramento.
From KXOA in Sacramento, of course. Remember the bevy of beauties we got from Sacramento?
The ringers
for the Naughty Nighty contest. And as I look at her picture, I'm noticing nice shadowing. A red light coming in from her left side.
Some filtering going on
makes
with the lighting.
Yeah, it's like almost the light of a sunrise on her. Very nice. She's got the pierced ones.
Door knockers, yeah.
The door knocker things, which I am not a big fan of.
Anthony?
I don't like the piercings, but she wears them well.
She's got a pimple.
Where's that? A little blemish on the left
little
one?
Little pimple.
Can be picky?
Yes.
Hold of yourself.
There's a pimple.
Well,
who cares?
It'll go away. I guess he's looking right here.
There's a little pimple.
That you notice?
Yes.
They're awful.
She's beautiful.
Oh.
I don't like the pierced ones because they see how it makes them look? They're constantly like in that aroused state.
Oh, that's terrible.
I don't know. It is. If they're constantly like that. Don't you like them to sometimes be just normal?
No.
No. You should look at you. No.
I'm not a pierced fan, though. I agree with you on that one.
No, you want to know when you're making that happen.
When you're making it work.
No, I don't. I'll just make the assumption that it's whenever I'm touching.
You don't want them, maybe if you run your hand over them, to just feel totally soft for a little bit.
Do you understand my ineptness?
Yeah, I'm asking the wrong person. Opie.
I'm with
you.
I'm totally with you.
Yeah, like sometimes if you run your hand over it and it's just all soft
at
first,
nice.
And then you start feeling it coming around.
And then you go, look what I did.
Look what I did now. Look what I did here now.
Look what I did.
So you're in the humiliating
position.
Like
it was yesterday. But it's today.
Today, so close to yesterday.
Anyway, the WOW contest is on.
Mm-hmm.
The three awesome blondes, we got their pictures taken, most of them?
Yep. All right,
They have entered the WOW contest. We're putting their pictures up. What city are they representing? They're not from New York, huh?
D.C.
D.C. representing.
Yeah.
All right. Basically, the ladies, if they want in on this contest, we got $5,000 up for grabs, courtesy of RiskeVideo.com, Anthony.
By the way, That's $5,000. I don't think people hear.
$5,000 to do what you want with. RisqueVideo.com, R-I-S-Q-U-E video.com. Check mm-hmm. them out, okay?
Yeah.
And all the ladies have to do is show up at the station they hear us on, and someone is waiting with the fine digital camera. They'll take your shots. They mail them to us, and we put all the shots up on opieandanthony.com. Eventually, the listeners will vote for the best wow. Easy peasy. And the shots we took of that girl in Boston. Ah. You guys got to see these pictures.
Which one was she?
The cafe latte.
No, she's Puerto Rican and Italian.
Well, she got a...
Oh, please. Puerto Rican and Italian is black.
Look, I'm not saying she's not built for prison. I'm just saying she's Puerto Rican and Italian.
Well, she looked black.
No,
she did.
She looked
cafe latte black, and there's nothing wrong with that.
I'm not saying there is. I'm just saying that she's Puerto Rican.
Have you corresponded with her at all, Jim?
She made that clear in an email, yes.
What did she do? All I know is I was leaving BCN Studios after the show, and I looked down, and Jim's like, E-A-T-R-B-U-L. And she's writing down, you know, some words, and then I see that at thing in there, so I know it's an email address.
Well, you know what the awful, this is absolutely true. She wants nothing to do with me sexually. A lot of women will email you and just say, hey, whatever. Nothing to do with me, sexually. It really annoys me.
Now you have a goal, though. So that's what you do. You're a conqueror.
She's hot, man. Pictures are hot.
All right. So go to opieandanthony.com for the WOW contest.
Okay? And New York, you know, what are we going to do? We got to give them an incentive because this happens every time. The New York women are completely jaded. They have taken this show for granted. The guys, you know, we saw with the stapler contest, they pour in. We say anything. Hey, we're going to pull your toenails out with pliers. Dude, count me in. The chicks? Hello? $5,000 up for grabs to come down here and have a fantastic picture of your bosoms taken for the WOW contest. You could win $5,000 if you're proud of your breasts and think they look nice enough to win when the audience votes. So some incentive.
First chick to come down to see us live here in New York.
Mm-hmm.
And enters the WOW contest.
Yes.
We'll get Incubus tickets.
Incubus.
To the sold-out show at the Garden.
Sold-out. Where is it?
Madison Square Garden.
Greatest arena in the world. The Madison Square Garden is greatest.
This is Aaron Sheik, World Wrestling Federation, three-time champion, All-American AAU champion. Pleasure for me to the Anthony and Opium. Bring me here to New York to I say hello to the, all my wrestling fans. And everybody know I'm the real Middle Eastern man, come to the greatest wrestling country and most famous city in the world, Manhattan, Madison Square Garden. I come three times champion. I want to say hello to the, all my wrestling fans, especially all American and also my Iranian friend, Khidmat Hamesh Shanavandagane. ایرانی عزیز سلام عرض میکنم همه دنیا آرون شیخ خسرو وزیری رو میشناسن. Pleasure for me to I come back here again one more time to I talk to the Opium and Anthony and pleasure for me always.
Opium. I never understood why he says that.
That never gets old.
Opium.
Hey, Paul, what's going on?
What's up, guys?
Hey.
Just wondering how things are going with your new coworker.
Who?
John Minnelli.
Ah, yes.
You guys must be very excited.
Yeah, the radio station here in New York City has...
He knows so much about radio.
Has hired a consultant. Are you trying to trash him already?
No.
We're happy.
Are you making jokes, Paul?
No, not at all. Not at all.
Yeah, they hired John Minnelli to consult this place.
Bob Grant used to... I recognize the name. I'm like, where do I know that from? And he was on Bob Grant's station. I used to...
Yeah.
Minnelli...
It's John Minnelli.
He's going to make some suggestions. We'll see what happens. He's looking for new shows.
That's right.
And I don't know. We're going to try to get this place together.
Get this going. Get some fire stoked in this place. That's all.
Hey, Brian, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys? How are you? You suck, Norton.
Hi, sir.
Thank you. Guys, I want to tell you, I've been listening to your show on hold. I tried to call in about Captain Kangaroo before.
Yes.
And, dude, let me tell you, this show on hold is 100 times funnier than it is live. You guys should just have a dump special.
Unfortunately, you heard a lot if you were on hold.
I was on hold for like 45 minutes. I couldn't hang up because I was laughing so hard.
There was 31 dumps so far.
I think half of them were Tippy Tom.
Tippy Tom. Oh, you heard when he said he wanted to F her face.
And I almost died. I swear to God, I almost died.
All right, cool.
Guys, you suck. I'm punching out.
All thank right. you, man. Hey, Jim, you're next on the Opie and Anthony Show. What's up?
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Good.
I wanted to give you a 10-second imitation of what we've heard today.
Okay.
It went, it went something like this. Tippy Tom, what do you think of... Wait a second. Hold it. Dumb Flanagan. Hold it. Wait. Hold it. It's been just great. Just great radio. God, you guys suck. We thought June 7th was bad.
That is so true. It's like, okay, Tippy Tom, you want to talk about... No. Get him away. It was more like this, though. Yeah, I think Tippy Tom, you could say what you want to say.
All right.
Yeah, we have confidence that you know the rules of radio.
No,
get him away. It's the worst catastrophe I've ever seen. Oh, no.
I got to tell you a little story. This guy, it's a sucks to be you story, mm-hmm. out of Birmingham, Alabama. Woman enraged at her boyfriend attacks him with a utility knife, cut off nearly all of his buttocks.
What?
Yeah, usually it's the other side, leaving him near death. On a dark rural road. Injuries were so severe, the investigators initially believed the victim was sexually tortured and dragged behind a car in a possible hate crime. The man has not fully described what happened, but him and his girlfriend, who was acted alone in this crime, had an argument at a bar. And Kimberly King, 26, of Aliceville, Alabama, was jailed and said, "This ain't right." That was her comment. She told TV crews that she was arrested. This ain't right.
What are you doing while someone is stabbing your balloon knot? Don't you move or fight back?
She apparently had a big utility knife and stabbed him. He fell down on his stomach, and she started carving his entire rear end off. Like, I'm gonna tear up your ass. And she did. She cut off. Man. I have never heard of that. Usually women... turn around and, you know, pull the bobbit on their guys if they're giving the women some crap. But, ow, that is a sucks to be you when your chick cuts off your ass. your chick cut off your ass.
I don't think you'll ever win another argument for the rest of your life.
That ain't right. Rob.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, Rob. From Reno.
Hey.
The first.
Yeah, I was just wondering when we're going to get some wow stickers and stuff out here.
The first official caller from Reno. Listening to us on the Hawk.
On the Hawk.
Classic rock that really rocks the Hawk. You're listening to the Hawk. Here's Ted Nugent.
When are we going to get the wow sticker?
Do classic rock stations play Cat Scratch Fever?
Hell yeah, man.
That's classic rock that rocks.
Classic rock that rocks.
Rocks.
The Hawk. Anyway, Rob, what? You want wow stickers?
Yeah.
I don't know. Is that up to the stations?
See, you're going to have to stay on these guys because they're going to be like more closely affiliated to like... You know, your New Orleans station there.
Rob, it's really... It's real easy. If you want to participate in WOW, just make the homemade WOW sign.
Well, yeah, I drive a truck. I got it written in the dirt on the back of my trailer.
Yeah, that works.
All right, right on. All right, we got to go because we got to
get the lead
right.
out.
You guys have a good one.
On the horn.
Not going to work, sir.
Classic rock that really rocks. Cat Scratch Fever. Ted Nugent on the Hawk. Classic rock that rocks. Rockin' Reno.
I usually don't hear, like, I would kind of enjoy hearing this on a classic rock station.
They usually play the same old stuff. At least around here.
This is classic rock that rocks. It's time for the 5 o'clock traffic jam on the Hawk.
What's with the rock stations playing a lot of old stuff nowadays? What is that all about?
It used to just be, you know, you could go to a station like, K-Rock or anything, and they used to just add in some Zeppelin. And what else did they put in there? Maybe some Floyd.
Hendrix.
Now it's like just... I'm waiting to hear CCR.
Have they just run out of new music? Is that what happened?
Dude, all the new music stinks.
Well, coming from you.
Except for, I know, Ozzy.
Hey, it's funny. Everybody's been teasing me about Ozzy, and you know what? What's happened in the last 6 months? The whole stupid country now is on the Norton Ozzy bandwagon.
It's nothing about his music.
It doesn't matter. It's the whole vibe, man.
Dude, oh, you picked up on that before people had watched him in his house?
You know, even hold on. Even with all that marketing he got with that show, his record sales stink.
Doesn't matter. Because the people are stealing up the internet. They're downloading everybody's
stuff. They're not interested in Ozzy's music. They're interested in seeing Ozzy look like a complete idiot on TV.
You're completely wrong.
It's the whole Ozzy vibe. I'm saying music, who he is, all of it makes him Ozzy.
No one knew. 99% of people, especially even Ozzy fans, never knew Ozzy was like that.
Anyway, I have interviews from him from Detroit in like before Randy died, like the early 80s, where he's drunk on the air. I've known Ozzy.
Yeah, that's fine. That's rock star drunk, not poor father walking around his house drunk.
But they're all into the whole vibe now.
You think?
No, dude, they are. No. I've been loving Ozzy for all these years.
No, his record sales stink.
People, everyone sells.
The whole reason they did the TV show.
Ben?
The whole reason they did the TV show with Sharon wanted to do this TV show was to help his record
promote
sales.
The album.
Exactly, dude. You talk about the internet, then why did Eminem? Why is Eminem already over 2 million? In 3 weeks, he's at 2.4 million.
Oh boy.
And that's, he was already all, that was all, if you're saying, that album was available on the internet.
Right. That's because we played
what's
it.
What's Ozzy's album up to, Earl? Did it even sell a million copies? It was a bomb.
You're delusional.
It cracked a million.
Dude, it was a bomb. It was because of the show.
With
the
all
last
the
last one that just came out. I don't
with
know
all the marketing that he got for the for his name, for his music, that's a disgrace.
Hours of commercial time on MTV, which is the record-buying public, and still couldn't...
Ozzy and Eminem, come on, man. Eminem, I mean, I like Eminem, but when he's doing it 20 or 30 years after he starts, then come talk to me. I don't want to hear about any music.
I don't like that excuse either.
That's a stupid excuse.
I don't like that one, too.
Some of these bands should give up after a few years.
Ozzy's phenomenal. You guys know that.
I think Ozzy is, but you know something? I'm going to be the first one to say this. Here comes my announcement. I think I'm the first person that has said this. I'm feeling the Osbourne overexposure.
Of course.
I'm feeling the Osbourne overexposure. I doubt
the second season
is
going to
do well.
It's just going to stink.
It's going to be a bomb.
It's going to be a
huge because now I've noticed
mistake.
The kids aren't acting like themselves, like in that awkward first couple of episodes. Now they're kind of pros at it, and they're kind of showing off. You see them on the interview shows and on the MTV award shows. And they're all, like, playing the characters
that are
themselves.
The reason the Osbournes worked so well, because they were all so innocent.
Yeah, now
and
it's...
And what? There was a lot of innocence as far as that show went. It was real.
They weren't used to being on TV.
It was taped, and they threw it on MTV. They weren't expecting it to be just a monstrous hit. And now, like Ann said, now that it is a monstrous hit, that you know they're playing to the cameras more, and they're overdoing it.
Every shot now, I'll tell you what every shot is: Ozzy looking all silly and stupid, maybe putting his Ozzy monster face on. Sharon looking in control; she's got to make that look. The daughter looking like she doesn't want to be there, and the son looking all like crazy. That's like every picture now of them is like that because that's what everyone expects of them.
At least they took a year to get to that point. Tommy Lee is talking about people, hey, you know, maybe they should film me. You know how long it would take him to ham it up? 30 seconds.
You know what, though?
Once you bang Pam Anderson on camera, nobody wants to see your next
part. They film a kid falling in the pool. I'm going to... I'm watching that one.
God, why didn't I think of that?
Unfortunately, because of the success of the Osbournes, you're going to see a lot of these shows.
Of course you will,
They're all going to fail in comparison, but the second season of the Osbournes is going to be awful, too.
It may not be as good, but I think it'll still be good.
It's going to be awful.
It won't be awful.
And this just in, there's going to be an entire collection of the Osbournes toys.
As there should be.
That are coming out, I guess, action figures. Is that what's happening? A little overexposure.
And you're
delusional
to think everyone's into Ozzy because of who he is.
No, I'm not.
They're into him because what they get to see on TV.
What I'm saying
He's a mess, and people love to get a peek at that.
But you know what? He's honest enough to let people.
They're giggling and laughing when they show the concert footage of Ozzy. He doesn't compare to 10, 15 years
ago.
Jim, he can't even move on stage.
Dude,
you know that people watch that show to laugh at him.
So what if? Life was fair, Ozzy would have been dead in 1984. He's had all these years of shooting Demerol, and he's still going. I don't care what he does anymore.
Buy my Ozzy Osbourne Happy Meal from McDonald's.
That's coming soon.
It's just annoying. That's the point. Everybody jumps on this Ozzy bandwagon now, and it's like people who have liked them. We could have told you this 20 years ago.
They're not jumping on the same bandwagon as you.
Yes,
they are. They're not discovering his music for the most part.
It's not just
they're
the
not buying his new music. They're looking at him on TV because he looks ridiculous.
What percentage would you say of people that watch the Osbournes actually know who Black Sabbath is?
Hard to say because a lot of people that are way too young or like, black
less
and Puerto
10%.
Rican guys that may not have listened to Ozzy before.
Mm-hmm. Less than 10%.
Less than 10%. Come on, stop. Maybe the whole
audience watching the Osbournes, you think more than
10%? I would say less than 10%.
Know who Black Sabbath is?
Yeah, definitely. I would say less than
35%. 35%. Know who Sabbath is.
Dude, you're insane.
They're not fans.
You're
insane.
They're not super fans like you, Jim.
But I
they
wouldn't
know
even
who
say.
Sabbath crazy. Is. They don't know what Sabbath is.
Sure they do.
No, they don't.
The average kids that watch MTV that are watching Eminem have no idea who Black Sabbath is.
Absolutely they do.
No, they don't.
They may not be fans. They may not be able to name songs, but they know who they are.
Dude, they know Eminem. They know System of a Down. They know Korn. They know those bands. They don't know any of them.
Because these bands, most of them have been, they're all on Sabbath tribute albums. All these bands have done nothing but pay homage to Sabbath.
Sabbath.
You are amazing.
Dude,
it's true.
You love Sabbath.
They're all on Sabbath tribute albums.
Ozzy's our savior.
All of them have done Sabbath covers. Never.
Look at Ben, he's falling off his chair.
You're insane.
Ben just fell off his chair.
You're absolutely insane.
I'm not. I do have a great Ozzy singing Staying Alive. That's phenomenal. That's a cover of Bee Gees Ozzy did, which was very acceptable.
You're insane.
I'm not, sure. I'm right.
You're insane.
I'm 100% right.
Well, I hate to tell you,
but there are better bands than Ozzy.
And I will say,
Better bands than Black Sabbath.
You know what? Yeah, the Beatles was a better band. I like Sabbath better, but the Beatles was better than Sabbath. I mean, I'm not dumb. I know that. But who else is better? The Who? That overrated, annoying... Right.
That's a completely different animal.
Led Zeppelin.
Great band. Overrated in comparison with Sabbath because critics liked them because of what they sang about as opposed to Sabbath, who was really dark and
awful. The critics really didn't like Zeppelin that much.
But they hated Sabbath.
Well, yeah.
They did not like Zeppelin at the time either. They thought they were devil worshippers.
Are you going to tell me that Sabbath shouldn't be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, which should be Firebomb? If they're sending Anthrax, please. That's the first place you should send it. How is Sabbath not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? How are they not? These pukey, like, Rolling Stern, Stone people.
Just because... Rolling Stern, he says. These pukey Rolling Stern people.
What are you talking about?
But no, you don't think Sabbath
they've been around so long?
No, but
is
they
that
didn't
the
sell out and start if singing ballads?
If there's somebody around that has been around for years, they should be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
I'm saying because the stuff was great. Every album was different. Maybe it wasn't that great. Volume 4, Sabbath, Bloody Sabbath, Master Reality. Come on. I mean, Paranoid, everybody knows. Remember the original Black Sabbath, or even some stuff off of Attentive Glacier Sea, or Never Say Die.
What's the criteria for being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Apparently, it's wearing robes and being a faggot and selling out and doing ballads for films. Apparently, that's the criteria.
All right, what band are you talking about?
None. I'm just saying in general.
Are you talking about Aerosmith?
No, I'm just generalizing.
You are.
You know, or have died in the 70s. If you died in the 70s, you're accepted in. Well, Bonham's dead, or I vote him out.
Aerosmith did a few ballads. Who cares? But they also rocked for many, many years.
I like Aerosmith. I do like Aerosmith.
I get pissed off when people say Aerosmith sold out. You can hate their music now or something, but how can you fault a band that nearly killed themselves with drugs?
I like them.
And once they came back, think that they should do it again? It's like the drunk friend that has the other friend that went on the wagon and is all pissed off that they're not still drinking. You got to give it to Aerosmith and let them just do what they do now. If they're making money hand over fist, writing ballads, writing movie soundtracks, you don't have to like it or listen to it, but you can't fault them and go, they should be doing drugs in their Learjet
and
writing crappy tunes and performing them like crap live.
I agree. I'm not saying you're wrong. I'm not knocking Aerosmith. My point is, what doesn't bother me is not Aerosmith or any band. It's the perception by people who vote you in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. It's these arrogant, stupid critics.
See Ozzy's new video?
No, I don't watch him.
Going with the little girls and the snow falling?
No,
and...
although I Just Want You is one of the best videos I've ever seen, and that probably got three plays on
it. Of course it is.
And the new song, the hit that's out, is very hokey.
I think to get into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, you have to have a little longevity, and there wasn't a lot of longevity with Black Sabbath.
There was 10 years.
That's getting there.
They did great stuff, man. They did great stuff. Some of the riffs come out. How can anybody question? I only riffs.
Hi, Boo Boo. Hi, Sugar Bear. How are you guys?
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up, Ozzy?
All right, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate Jimmy, you know, sticking up for me. I love him, you know. I just want to say, though, I kind of agree myself that I'm a little overexposed, you know.
Yeah.
No, it's because I've been doing the Ozfest this summer. And I go by, you know, do the show on stage and... You know, I used to see all the kids, you know, singing along with the songs, and now, you know, they just know me from the show, you know. And they're taking, you know, good tickets from people who are my real fans, you know. I just agree with what you're saying.
Ozzy, I think you're a little overexposed. I think a lot of people now are almost, you know, I dare say it, getting a little tired of your family.
Oh, you too. I'm getting tired of it myself, you know. I just want to say, you know, I agree with what you're saying, and I don't know, I'll always be able to tell my true fans that I genuinely love the guys, you know. I just want to say that, and I figured I'd chime in, you know. That's all I got.
And I disagree with overexposed.
Look at this guy, Payback from Toms River, Jersey. Way to go, Jimmy. Led Zeppelin, the most overrated band ever. They stink and I don't like them. Right under that, Norton, you effing moron. Don't even insinuate that Ozzy and his S band are even in the same language as Led Zeppelin.
And I'm not knocking Zeppelin, dude. I like them. I'm saying...
You just did!
I did not.
You said you're overrated.
In comparison with the way the critics saw them compared to Sabbath. No one said Zeppelin wasn't great.
Zeppelin never made a bad song. Well, hot dog.
Come on. They were a great band.
Other people saying that.
Blow.
How many of those riffs were more interesting than what Iommi was writing? It was all perception. Wow, Zeppelin is so hip. I mean, I like Zeppelin.
Zeppelin didn't have interesting riffs?
Of course they did.
Are you insane?
Of course they did. But why isn't Iommi with his three missing fingers?
Led Zeppelin, greatest band of all time.
Absolutely not.
End of story.
Not even better than the Beatles.
Rob from Columbus and Todd from Cleveland both chiming in here. Hey, Norton, shut the F up. Ozzy doesn't want Black Sabbath in the Hall of Fame.
Because they kept rejecting him. He took them off the ballot, stupid, in Cleveland.
Ozzy refused to be accepted into the Hall of Fame, you dope.
Because they kept rejecting them, and Ozzy got tired of it. Good for Ozzy. Why shouldn't he get tired of it?
Why wouldn't he just let it ride?
As far as overexposure is concerned, but Seinfeld was on the air for 10 years. How much overexposure? Or any of those other guys? Or Schwarzenegger has been a figure for 20
it's
years.
It's different when you can go on a show like Seinfeld and have writers that write situations and not just put a camera on Ozzy and his family.
Seinfeld had a little more substance than the Osbournes.
You know, all of a sudden he's at the White House.
I like Seinfeld, but he had more substance.
He's at the White House.
Of course there was more substance during the Seinfeld years than the Osbournes.
What do you mean by substance, though? There was better comedy writing.
How many seasons of the Osbournes are you going to be able to take before you want to puke?
I say it dies next season. It's done.
Of course.
It's
probably
done.
Yes, probably.
The reason Seinfeld was on the air so long is because of substance, great writing, and great characters.
No, I don't agree.
The Osbournes are just one-trick ponies, man, and that's okay. We had fun with it.
It's not even a one-trick
pony. But it's gonna die real fast next year.
I think next year it might not be as strong, but so what? He'll get 2 years, they get $20 million, which they deserve, for all the videos that MTV didn't show.
Oh,
please, how did I just want you...
Oh, my
that
God.
Video, how did that video not get shown constantly?
Oh, my God.
Even as a non-Ozzy fan, you have to look at that video and go,
dude,
wow, that was a well...
when MTV so first started, all
exactly.
you saw was Paranoid. And
Paranoid, Children of the Grave, and Iron Man, shot from that 1982
I'm
California
I'm just so
concert.
Glad that this man has a passion for something else besides sex.
I know. To see him sex with Ozzy would be an amazing conversation
I
with
respect,
Norton.
I respect, I probably would. I would
sex
I
with Ozzy.
I wouldn't have sex with him because I'm not gay, but I might give him a handy out of respect.
All right, Ozzy.
Hi, guys.
Humming Iron Man.
I might actually be up for that, too, Jimmy. I just wanted to say another thing. It's like Ben was mentioning before, you know, that all the kids are into, you know, Eminem and all that stuff. And I think these days, more, you know, kids are a product of their society. You see all these, you know, everybody's into rap and wearing the pants around their ankles, you know. I just think, you know, so music like mine's doomed, you know, because everybody's, you know, turning into rap, you know. I just think, you know, that I don't know, man. I don't know what to say.
Even hip hop has to keep changing. Like, I think they're at a point now. We were talking about this in the office. Music itself is at a point where something's got to pop.
Hey, Jim.
Yes, it's retarded.
The reality is your hero is becoming a joke.
Not at all. Absolutely
yes, he
not.
Is.
Yeah. Absolutely not.
Someone wrote on the screen, Ozzy Osbourne is the Muhammad Ali of rock and roll.
No. People watch the show Muhammad to goof on Ozzy. Yeah.
Muhammad Ali used to be a great, great fighter.
Now, there's something humble about him.
With a quick wit.
And there's something honest about him. Humble. That people like. There's a non-arrogance in allowing people to see you like that in your natural environment, because we're all a mess at home. There is an absolute honesty in that, and that's what people like about the guy. He's not. When's the last time Ozzy made a political speech? Never. He's not a pompous ass. He doesn't matter. He doesn't try to. None of them can, but it doesn't stop them from trying. None of these douchebags can.
All right, Ozzy.
They all try to sound like geniuses. Ozzy doesn't care. Yeah, I used to drink. Sometimes I still do. Oh, well. Good for him. Tell him the truth. That's why people like it. Dumb Americans are finally enjoying someone with a body like E.T. telling the truth.
All right. I'll see everybody at Ozfest. I love you, Sugar Bears, and I'll see you later.
All right, Ozzy.
Love you, Ozzy. Love you, Sharon.
I think more so they just like watching him stumble about the house.
That's part of it, sure, but let him enjoy it.
That's a huge part of it.
Doesn't matter, man. Doesn't matter. Good for Ozzy. Let him laugh all the way. $20 million for the next season.
Seeing Ozzy work out before his tour, we're laughing
with
at
his
him.
Let's Get Physical.
We're not laughing
on.
With him. We're laughing at
let's
him.
Let's Get this Physical.
Is, that's the reality
physical.
Of it. Bottom line is this. He's 50-something years old. He has done more dope than everybody in this room, and he is still doing shows. How can anybody not like that? How can anybody not
I
respect
I can respect that.
That.
I just think it's kind of over.
Please, where's Robert Plant? Where's any of these guys from the 70s? Or even Styx from the 80s couldn't make it.
Thank God Robert Plant isn't doing anything. That's something.
Oh, the Who, boy, they're going to be really energetic on stage.
And you know
like 70?
What? Is he going to show up?
Dude, who was supposed to open for the Who last time?
I guarantee you the Who
is
more energetic on stage than Ozzy.
At this age,
you're insane. All the footage they show of Ozzy on the stage during that Osbournes, he's barely moving.
I'll tell you why they have more energy, because they haven't done gigs since 1978. Nobody cares about Quadrophenia.
The Who has been touring off and on. They never really retired.
Nobody likes the
They
Who
had about
stink.
10 or 12 farewell tours.
Exactly.
They've never really gone away.
The Who sells out. Just
know,
days on end
you're right,
at major venues.
And you know what? Bin Laden's very popular in certain parts of the world. It doesn't mean I enjoy his music.
Oh my God, he's comparing The Who and Bin Laden.
The Who is as old as Ozzy, but they definitely move
got more
around a lot more.
Yeah, well, again, yeah, so what, man? They stink. Nobody likes The Who.
Well, you were talking about energy.
Yeah, no. They've been off for a while. Nobody cares about them.
Nobody cares about
them. He's an animal. There's no one better alive than Ozzy. He's a little older now, so what? He's a maniac. How do you not love him?
Can he still hit the notes? Live?
No, that's the beauty of him. He's not like Britney Spears lip syncing like a dope.
I'm not talking about that, but I'd be able to hit the notes.
Saying,
I like
why
it.
Why
that's
are we
something
talking about
I,
Britney Spears?
Because again, this is how dumb people are. She's so popular and wonderful, and she can't even sing live. Right. At least Ozzy just does what he does without hiding it. That's why I like it.
People watch Britney just to look at the hot body.
Not 16-year-old girls don't. Most of the public goes, they really think she's terrific. Gay guys don't, and they love her.
Gay guys don't love Britney?
Yes, they do. Have
you read an article that gay guys like Britney Spears?
They like NSYNC.
Whatever they like. I mean, we don't know what they really like deep down.
All right, we got
yeah,
a break.
She is what they want to be.
Robert Plant, I must say, the worst live. The guy could not sing those songs live. Doing them in the studio, and you'd hear the albums, and then live, it's
and
I'm not even talking about after he got older.
He had to put his yam bag in a vice to hit those notes.
Oh, well, yeah, that sucked. That's why I have a problem with
it. Ozzy plows through it, and he is who he is. He doesn't hide, and he doesn't try to be pompous and political. He's just a rocker, man. That's why I love him. He's the greatest.
Of course he is.
He is the greatest.
Of course.
Nothing pompous about him.
Of course.
I'm right, though.
You have no clue that Sharon's using her own husband.
No, she's not. She made it. Look,
please.
Sharon, are you the
brand
of Sharon Osbourne? She's kept Ozzy
please.
Relevant in his 50s.
Maybe Ozzy
no,
doesn't want
wrong.
To be relevant
you're
anymore.
She is a genius. To keep Ozzy relevant through glam metal, through everything, after he was in the dumps,
she's
had to
taking
leave
advantage
Sabbath?
Of her own husband.
Absolutely not. They're
of
rich
course
beyond
she is.
Belief. Not at all. She's
watch,
brilliant.
Watch
man.
The show again.
Sharon is brilliant.
Half the things Ozzy doesn't even want to do.
Please. Exactly, and that's the beauty of her. No, keep
why
going.
Is it? Why?
Why does he have a hit show
why?
At 50
why? Does he need the money that bad?
No, man. Does anybody?
He needs,
Schwarzenegger?
He needs people to watch a show and laugh and ridicule him?
That's not what it's about, man. That's not what it's about at all. The whole family, they're just a regular family. They're honest, the nerve of them to be honest in America on TV. That's what they are. They're honest. They're not trying to be cute. They don't have chiseled chins. They don't have cute, perfect lines written for them. Hey, here comes the wacky kid. Waka waka. They're just real people. No. He doesn't hit his family. There's no abuse.
That's just
they
it. No, they're not.
So
they're
what?
Not being real.
They are.
No.
The first couple ones, yes.
The first couple they were.
You guys are forgetting
now
this.
It's...
They were being filmed. The whole season was probably shot before any of them were shown. So how can you say that they're watching themselves and becoming caricatures of themselves? Now that the season was probably shot
Well, now that the
shown.
Season has been shown and they've had time, yeah, of course.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
We're on
I
TV.
See it on the talk shows. They're trying to do situations like you saw in the show
okay,
on the talk
maybe.
Shows live. Oh, look, they're fighting again. It's
maybe.
Like,
you
no, they're
right.
not.
Yeah. I don't. To be honest with you, I don't know. But again, this is a rock family thrown into this situation. Let's see. There's no precedent for it. How do you handle it? This is the first time it's being done, so give the guys a break. How about live TV back in the 50s? They did certain things you look back on and go, ugh, that was kind of sketchy.
Right. Bill, what's up?
Hey, guys, what's going on? I'm just calling because I got to agree with Norton with this whole, you know, Led Zeppelin's overrated. I'm sick and tired of Stairway to Heaven, but this whole thing with Ozzy Bond. Hey, Norton.
How could they even think I would fall for that?
That was so bad.
I am theoretically holding hands with Ozzy. How can you think I would fall for that, sir?
Oh, my
Stop.
God.
Stop. I'm not saying Zeppelin's not a great band. Of
Howie from Buffalo's got a question. Did you like Sabbath with Ronnie James?
Jay, they did. Look, man, they did. The Heaven and Hell and Mob Rules were good albums. I even liked Live Evil, which would sound like a studio album.
Look how he goes off.
In the back.
He goes, he should be in a basement with your little friends and a pentagram on the floor just talking about Ozzy.
I liked Dio.
Ma! No, I'm down here.
No, I
Ma,
like Dio.
I'm doing things.
Dio was actually Dio wanted.
I feel like I'm watching Spinal Tap.
Yeah.
Ozzy wanted Dio to open for them. Dio.
Oh wow, fascinating.
No, but Dio said no. That's
real
Ozzy.
Fascinating.
What's a lot of people it might be.
Yeah.
All right.
Ozzy lasted through everything. Glam metal, grunge, all that crap, and he's still relevant.
Lasted through it. Some of that glam metal stuff with Ozzy with his big hair.
I agree. He looked like Bette Midler with the painted things and the doves. I didn't say Shot in the Dark wasn't an awful video. I agree. It was terrible.
Shot in the Dark.
But good for him to have a commercial hit. So what? If the dummies in America aren't going to put on Lord of This World or Into the Void or Supernaut, let them enjoy that.
Look how he rattles them off. I love this
We got to take a break, okay?
All right.
We have a pair of... U.S. Open golf tickets to give away.
Oh!
For tomorrow, though. So what are we going to do? We
That's
only have 40 minutes left in the show.
Tricky card there, Maggie. Very tricky.
We'll try to figure it out.
I love you all. I love you more than life itself. You're all f***ing mad.
The current IT boys of FM Talk are the New York-based duo of Opie and Anthony. And the talk is racy and raw at times, pushing the limits as far as they can.
Show your hairy pork chop. My mother smokes crack rock. I'm for drunk teens. What are you kidding?
How about I lay you down and give you a little bukkake? We laugh.
We're going to have a disgusting body fluid blowout.
Gay porn.
Hey, could you soap up your bad place?
The sluttier the better.
I would definitely be willing to have sex with you if we both already had AIDS.
It's certainly not your father's talk radio.
Opie and Anthony Show.
And we're running out of show. This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Getting ready to play What Do We Learn on the O&A Show today.
Yeah.
Jim Norton losing his mind today.
Really is.
Jim, you got to agree with this one. Randy Rhoads?
Yes.
The most overrated guitarist ever.
Ridiculous.
Ever.
That's what that is. Here's what that is. That's a shock value statement that has no merit. Because Randy was a classical guitarist. He was brilliant. Everybody knows he was great. He wasn't overrated at all. Not at all. When's the last time you heard Randy's work played on stupid classic rock? Faggot classic rock station that will play Jimmy Page until the cows come home, but won't play Randy. That really annoys me.
If he didn't die, he'd be still touring, and he'd be like a has-been.
Nah, I would have left Ozzy years ago, man. Randy was a brilliant musician.
If he was still alive, he'd be like Tommy Shaw.
And here's another great thing. Well, no, stop it. Hey, first of all, the only thing they had in common was the mullet, but at least Randy was a great, brilliant musician.
Randy would have been in the Traveling Wilburys.
No, he would have left his own.
Yeah, I think Randy Rhoads would have been a Traveling Wilbury.
A Wilbury.
I think that makes a good point.
They did Diary of a Madman.
Sometimes it's good to die early.
And the same time that they did Diary and Blizzard of Oz, we got Randy on two albums. We got very, very lucky.
I mean, I'm sad that he's gone, but, you know, I think it might have helped his longevity that he died early.
And as far as Ozzy fans not knowing this stuff until we saw the Osbournes, that's not true at all, man. If you're an Ozzy fan, you know, I used to have a picture of their wedding picture on my wall when I was growing up. In 82 when they got married in Hawaii.
MTV did some kind of survey with kids, and 87% of them didn't even know who the Beatles were. So,
I know, they
all right.
I agree.
But they're going to know who Black Sabbath is?
Oh, because of Ozzy. And then, 87% of kids. Go ahead, let them put on trench coats and shoot each other, these little dummies. Who cares what they know? They're stupid. But a bunch of bad parents and dumb kids.
You said 35% of the people that watch the Osbournes know who Black Sabbath was.
I absolutely think they would.
I don't know.
And as far as the Beatles are concerned...
They may know the name because it was mentioned in the show, but I bet you they couldn't name one Black Sabbath song.
I didn't say they could. I just said they would know who Sabbath is. And you want to talk about Sharon being a manager. How relevant was McCartney if you left the Beatles? Band on the Run.
Let's sold a lot of records.
So, love him or hate him, he had a good run, run with Wings.
But he was awful in Wings. And everybody knows he was awful in Wings.
He was not.
That was terrible. That was a giant,
If you want to make an
fan.
Argument, that stupid song he did with Michael Jackson, then you're onto something.
Oh, yeah. Ebony and Ivory. Well,
he had a good run with Wings.
They live side by side on my keyboard. Why can't we? I don't know. Maybe because the black keys on the keyboard don't beat up the white keys. Stupid.
Say was Michael Jackson.
That stunk, too.
Say.
Oh, he's dressed like a Bowery boy.
Yeah, but you lost your argument by saying Wings.
They were terrible. I haven't lost my argument. They were awful. I don't care how much they sold.
Let me tell you something. I'm
not. Ian Carter sold a lot of cocaine. Doesn't mean I enjoyed
their
work.
I was never a Wings fan, but they were a respectable band.
Yeah, by the critics, of course they were respectable.
Guns N' Roses seemed to like tune enough to recover it.
And they seem more Zeppelin influenced than Sabbath influenced. Guns N' Roses, phenomenal band.
But I'm saying they saw enough in a Wings tune to cover it.
Big deal. They covered Knocking on Heaven's Door, too. So what? Sabbath did an Evil Woman cover on some issues of the first album. Does that mean it was a great band? No. Who cares what people covered? It doesn't mean anything to me.
Well, you were just saying that most people have covered Sabbath songs.
You're saying so people know who they are. I was only saying, I'm saying all these bands that have covered Sabbath songs on these Sabbath tribute albums.
Randy Rhoads,
so their
overrated.
Fans know who they were.
Randy Rhoads, overrated.
Look, you don't believe, that has nothing to, can I?
Look, you don't believe that. Look, he's dumb.
Can I pull this, can I mention this?
What?
Can I mention this? I got to mention it tomorrow. I have to mention this.
What the hell's wrong with you?
I'm doing Westbury Music Fair on September 7th. Tickets go on sale tomorrow at 12:30.
That's September. It's June.
I'm just telling you when they go on sale. Don't yell at me. I don't work in the office. My agent called me, and I'm reporting it to you. I wish Sharon was my manager.
Another we will case. Allow you to plug this show over and over and over again until it sells out.
To mention it going
if you admit on our show that Randy Rhoads was overrated.
Absolutely not. He is not overrated. He was
Who's
never
the better
overrated.
Guitarist, Randy Rhoads or Jimmy Page?
To be honest with you, it's a tough question, man, because Randy died at 26 years old.
Oh, God.
Dude, he was 26.
All right.
56 to 82.
We'll only use Jimmy Page's material from the first two Led Zeppelin albums. Who's better?
That's tough, man. I'm not going to just automatically say Randy because I love him so much because Page was a great, great guitarist. Dude, but no, it is close.
And no,
Randy
it's not
was
even
a brilliant. Randy was a brilliant guitarist.
It's not
Why?
Even close.
Because he didn't. What? Because he didn't do the
Jimmy Page. Jimmy Page on those first two albums came up with so many more licks than Randy Rhoads.
With his stupid double guitar that the dude from Cheap Trick used.
That was later on in his career. We're only talking about the first two albums, my friend.
Is he playing the top one or the bottom one? He should have been playing Surrender.
Dude, if Randy Rhoads was still around, he'd be playing the spinning guitar and the flying V's and stuff.
Probably
Relax.
Probably would have left Ozzy. He was playing the flying V when he was alive. He was playing that, the polka dot flying V. He probably would have left Ozzy in 83 or 84 because he would have moved on and done classical music.
No, he wouldn't have.
Yes, he would have. Ozzy admits that. Yes,
No. Here it goes. Look at this. Bobby from NYC. Ha ha, Opie, you laughable D. You worship that no-talent sack of S, Kurt Cobain, and you have the unmitigated gall to mention anything negative about Randy Rhoads. See? You don't think Cobain's suicide helped his longevity?
Of course it did!
You probably won't even have the balls to read this on the air.
Of course it did! He'd probably be making some pretty crappy tunes by now. Without a doubt! Without a doubt. But you can't admit it. And I said, Anthony, sometimes it's good to die,
early.
What can I admit? Randy was not overrated.
Randy Rhoads, if he was still around, would be doing some ridiculous things.
Not at all. Why?
Without a doubt.
Not necessarily true.
Because everyone does. Name one guy that isn't an embarrassment.
What do you mean?
Just as I was talking before we came back from break. The Beatles. You look at John Lennon, when he died, still hip, cool, New York guy, walking around with his dopey little glasses and whatnot. He gets killed. The other ones live. Yeah, did you see Paul McCartney at his wedding? He looks like an old woman, first of all, now. He's got he is not relevant in the least. And then they're filming him kissing his wife, and everyone's going, "Hey, Paul, give her a kiss." And he goes, "Okay, but just one..." Kisses over his wrinkled up little lips and goes, "If you missed it, that's all you get."
Good for McCartney.
It's like you don't want to kiss his girl. He's irrelevant. He's old and it's sad.
Why should he kiss his girl for the media? He sang yesterday. You just take your one-legged bride, throw her on the bed and bang her in the privacy of your own mansion. He shouldn't perform for these nobodies. Hey, give her a kiss.
I'm saying perform.
We can get a picture of you.
When you, when you look at the days where he had the big beard and he's singing Let It Be.
Exactly.
And then you look now, you're like, ah, gee, Lennon got off easy.
Good for McCartney. He shouldn't perform for a bunch of dirtbag paparazzi. Hey, we need to sell this to the Sun. Those scumbags, they do nothing but hound you, and he's supposed to kiss his nice wife because they asked for
it? You would think
it?
He would want to.
Who cares what well, maybe he didn't. Take her home, just look at her and go, wow, she really does only have one. And think about it. God, good for McCartney. And his new song was terrible, by the
kiss,
way.
He should kiss her because they invited the press there to take pictures.
That's yeah, absolutely. But so not to bark out orders.
Whatever they want.
Rick, if I invite
that's
you to my house.
Asking for.
If I invite
he's
you to my house.
You to come down, take pictures, cover this for the press, give me publicity.
Absolutely.
Well,
but
then give us something to press.
But he didn't hire Kubrick to direct it. He just had people come and take pictures of it as it was happening. Oh. He didn't say, all right, let
look
me know what
Keith,
you want me to
Keith
do.
Keith Moon died in a rock and roll fashion, man. Now legendary drummer of all time. You
yeah,
got
Bonham too.
Keith Moon. Bonham, exactly the same thing. And then you look at, you know.
Well, the nervous Sabbath to have some temerity to stay alive. Bill, Tony, Geezer, and Ozzy are all living.
Gee,
maybe Bill Ward just put a little weight on, but he's one of the most underrated drummers ever. He was not as good as Bonham. I know that.
Stop it.
Dude, not
don't even
was,
get into
not
that.
Not as good as Neil Peart, not as good as Bonham, but he was underrated.
There's another 50 drummers you can put in front of him.
Who?
Neil Peart, the greatest drummer of all time.
He was a great drummer. Neil Peart was great, man. Great. But who are you putting in front of Bill
no,
Ward?
No, John
was
Bonham
phenomenal.
Was right there, and
yes.
Keith Moon was right
there.
I would put
there.
Keith Moon,
all right,
yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Especially
right.
For the time, you know?
Also, that, the drummer from Winger.
Kaja Gugu's drummer was just phenomenal.
Yeah, he didn't get the respect he deserved.
Or Def Leppard. Maybe Rick Allen should have married McCartney's wife, and they could have just rolled around and looked at what should be there.
Uncle John.
Stupid puzzles with pieces missing.
Uncle John, what's up?
Sorry, guys.
You know, once again, the show started off really good. The middle stunk. And then we end up strong.
Having
again.
A little fun.
All right, what's up, Uncle John?
I just got what did I learn?
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I learned if you're walking around downtown, don't look behind any dumpsters.
No doubt. Hey, Uncle John?
Yo.
Black Sabbath overrated, right?
You know, I got to side with Jim on this one.
Thank
sorry,
you, John. Guys. Thank you, buddy.
Have to.
You pussy.
He's right.
You pussy.
No, look at this one. No more free tickets for you.
It's the easier thing to do would be to side with
over. I'll pay my way, but I got to go for Sabbath.
I respect
you.
That. Look at this one. I love how Norton argues. He's quick, concise, and makes a point with each statement. He's passionate. Norton rocks.
Thank you, whoever that is.
There you go.
Maybe I should just put up a lighter and yell, "Do Stairway to Heaven again." The critics love that one. Hey, Black Dog.
What's wrong with Black Dog?
Nothing. The 800th time you hear it on the same effing classic rock station.
Yeah,
could those bags of vomit
that's
once.
That's not Zeppelin's problem.
I will agree with you.
They put the material out there, and then it's up to radio to decide which songs they're going to play.
I'm not saying Zeppelin wasn't even a great band. Radio stinks.
I will agree with you
when
on
the
that.
The last time you heard anything off Volume 4 by Sabbath? Never. Never. And you're going to tell me song? I'm serious, man. Well, it's Sabotage.
What song should radio be playing from Sabbath? I really need to hear this.
A National Acrobat, well, Volume 4. Would be I'm coming off of a Sabbath, Bloody Sabbath. That's what Sabbath is.
I love it.
Would be very nice
this.
To hear. A National Acrobat. That's the song I walk out to. It's, everybody said, dude, that song kicks ass. Who is it? Well, maybe it's your classic rock station.
There you go. No, they didn't know.
Because there's
your
only
own,
one verse.
Your own fans did not know you were walking out to Sabbath.
Because these faggot classic rock stations have never given it the play it deserved. Hey, put on Dream On again. We haven't heard that enough. Hey, do you want to hear maybe a Spiral Architect off of Sabbath, Bloody Sabbath? No. People won't just recognize that, and you can't go two for Tuesday or get the Sabbath out. You faggot DJs. Stick to your playlists, you faggots. It's the same. Put on My Generation again. We never get tired of hearing that. Or how about Brown Eyed Girl, you white trash zeros?
There are plenty of good things off of Quadrophenia that never get played on the radio.
I'm tired of the rock opera. You don't like both. You like one or the other. That conceptual nonsense. Nobody wants to hear it. Hey, here's Ozzy with the rock ballet. Nobody wants to hear that crap. It's awful.
Did he like Tommy by the Who?
No, I didn't like Tommy.
The whole album?
No.
He barks it.
No.
That was a great album.
It really maybe, was. When was it? 71 that was a good album, and you heard it enough on the radio. Enough with these crappy bands on the radio.
Oh, like Black Sabbath plays well today.
Dude, They still do. Look at Iommi and
Bill Gunn. The Who's Tommy plays better today than Black Sabbath.
Because the Who has been doing nothing but sleeping for the last 20 years. Nobody cared about them. At least Sabbath.
They tour all the time.
They suck. Nobody cares about them or stupid Roger Daltrey and his gimmicky tight jeans. Who's sick as stole that in Iron Maiden? Nobody cares about Daltrey
and tight
pants.
If the Who does five nights at Giant Stadium, it will sell out five nights.
You're absolutely right.
It's amazing.
I can't argue. You're right. They're a tremendously successful band. Sabbath never had that type of commercial success and never will. But they said the radio never gave them the play. The Cars never gave them the play.
Good.
No, come on. You can't. As anybody that knows music, you can't even argue that. Any band would argue
with
you.
They had a few good songs.
A few good
riffs.
Songs.
That's about it.
Can they stop playing Paranoid or War Pigs? How about something off of Sabotage? You're going to tell me you don't want to hear Hole in the Sky or Symptom of the Universe? The Writ, the thrill of it all? Of course you do.
If you were talking Star Trek, you would be the biggest Star Trek geek.
I knew the Admiral on the East Coast. You know everything. And I don't care about you 18-year-olds. Like, hey, dude, enough with Sam. Drop dead.
Is this the sequel to Spinal Tap? This is a sequel to Spinal Tap.
Listen to all your music now that is stealing from Sabbath anyway. Those great
Who
riffs.
Who steals from Sabbath?
A lot of the bands. I've heard a lot of so many of their riffs
coming
out.
All of them not.
And by the way, I'm tired of overrated Santana. He does some famous riff that is a ripoff of Rat Salad, I think, off Paranoid.
Uh-huh. Which riff?
I don't know. He doesn't even sing his own crappy. What's that new song he did, that awful...
It's smooth.
Stink song.
Smooth. That's about 7 years
old. Yeah, I know. They're critically acclaimed.
I never.
You know what? That was a great song.
That song was great.
The song was really good.
Yeah, you listen to it. Hey, I can tap my feet to that.
It was a good song, man. And that whole album was amazing.
Overrated.
I didn't think Santana was good.
With all the guest musicians and the guest singers.
Exactly. Where's Ozzy with the guest singers? Hey, guys, come on over. He doesn't need them.
Hey, Deuce, Randy Rosen, you know, wouldn't be able to put out an album singing.
No, and Randy wouldn't try. That's the beauty of
Carlos
Randy.
Santana doesn't want to try.
Man, nobody cares about that dopey fat man. He's awful.
He was all about playing the guitar.
Yeah, good for him. Let him do it.
Another guitar
in Mexico
is better than Randy Rhoads, by the way.
No.
Yes.
He's been around for 70 years.
Yes.
He is the most overrated guitarist.
Santana.
Hey, where's Yingbae in his 4 years of fame? Malmsteen. Anyone with an L and an M in their last name should not be listened to as a rock musician.
Yngwie Malmsteen?
No.
Better than Randy Rhoads.
No. Oh, come on, that sweetest fag. Nobody cares about him.
Santana.
Just awful. Take the Wawa bar and stab himself in the eye.
Nobody wants to hear it.
Carlos Santana.
It's a Wawa bar.
He's a great guitarist.
A whammy bar or a Wawa pedal, stupid.
All right, whatever it is. Exactly. That's why I don't know, because Randy never used that crap.
He admitted that he was playing the V guitars, the flying V. That was a gimmick.
Steve Vai is better than Randy Rhoads.
I'm not as familiar with Steve Vai's work.
The flying V was a gimmick guitar when it first came out.
How do you think he got some of those sounds without a whammy bar?
No, he did.
All that.
Suicide Solution.
Yeah,
phenomenal.
That's all whammy bar.
Phenomenal. So what? At least he didn't try to sing. All right, maybe. All right, I'll give you that point. He used the bar a lot better than that fat dummy did. I'll tell you that much. That stupid guy stealing from Sabbath. He stole from Sabbath. Nobody will ever admit that. Oh, Norton, you're crazy, but I'm not crazy. He took riffs from Sabbath's Paranoid album.
Well, prove it. We'll prove it on
our
show.
Jack the Stripper, I think, or Rat Salad, or something of the original.
Dude, you go home and do your research. We'll prove it right on the show.
I don't remember the sentence.
You're babbling now.
I'm not babbling.
Then go home and do your research.
Maybe I am babbling. I apologize.
Is there
you
a
find
point?
The riff that he ripped off, no, and we'll do it.
I don't remember the Santana song.
Well, someone will help you out. Email Jim Norton, tinkledrinker at AOL.
I'm not going to download and listen to Santana
song. No, but they'll tell you which riff it was, idiot.
They might not know.
Is there going to be a point on this program that we actually get to get Norton and Ozzy in the same room?
I've met Ozzy twice.
Yeah, but I want to see it.
I wouldn't be this nuts with him if he would freak him out. I would be quiet and mellow and hang and then just stare at him and make him uncomfortable again.
No, I want to get you all revved up so you could spew this off so Ozzy can just look at you and go, I love him.
No, he wouldn't.
I love this man.
No, he wouldn't say that. He would think I was an ass, and who is this maniacal lunatic? I wouldn't be like this in front of Ozzy because it would make him uncomfortable. No, I wouldn't. My own stupidity can wait. When he leaves, I can make an ass out of myself. No, I would be mellow out of respect for him.